3 call.
A beautiful night at Fenway Park for baseball's greatest rivalry, the New York Yankees and the Boston Red Sox in their first game of the season. Hi again, everybody. I'm Don Orsillo. Welcome to Red Sox Baseball and welcome to Red Sox Yankees. So far this season for the Red Sox, the pitching has been outstanding. For the Yankees, the offense. The two worlds collide here tonight. As we check out some of the numbers so far this season, it's been tremendous as the New York Yankees come in with a .283 team batting average. That is first. A-Rod leads the way in home runs and RBIs in the American League. 20 home runs, of which A-Rod has 10. The Red Sox pitching has been terrific, a 2.58 earned run average, only behind the New York Mets in the majors in earned run average, and only 8 home runs allowed so far this season for Boston. We welcome in Jerry Remy, and Jerry, Alex Rodriguez has been amazing so far this season.
Well, this whole Yankee lineup is probably the best in all of baseball, but Alex Rodriguez at the start of this season has been something special. This is like his MVP years. Now look, this guy has been a good player all along, but it's had big time troubles with the Yankee fans because he has not done it in postseason. But look at the start that he's had in the first 14 games. 10 home runs, 26 RBI, all first in the league. Just go on and on and on with the offensive numbers. Now, it seems to me that A-Rod is playing more relaxed this year for whatever reason that may be. And of course, as a baseball player, when you're more relaxed and more comfortable, you play better. Now he's got the fans on his side in New York. But you know, you kind of have the feeling, Don, that until he does it in postseason play, he's still going to be kind of a whipping boy for the New York fans. But this start that he has had going right now reminds me of when he was MVP. Like, he's never stopped being a great player. He's just had a couple of tough years in New York. Under normal conditions, they'd be very good years for people, but the Yankee fans have not accepted that.
Chapter number one of the 2007 Red Sox and Yankees book. It's next. And it features one of the hottest players in all the game, Alex Rodriguez.
Our neighbors. You teach. You cheer. You sacrifice. You help those around you. You love your little corner of the world. Here at Extra Mart, we are proud to serve you, and we thank you for letting us be a part of your community.
Visit the new extramart.com and sign up for the Extra Email Club and have a chance to win a PlayStation 3. Club members are the first to learn about great context, incredible sales, receive coupons, and more. Go to extramart.com today.
It's on, even when the lights aren't.
It's on when there's an emergency.
It's on whenever I need it.
With Verizon, if the power suddenly goes out, your phone stays on, and that's important. And now, when you add high-speed internet and TV to Verizon's reliable phone service, you get all three together on one bill for one low price. So sign up today. Verizon, it's the network.
Stormed beaches and freed countries. They've raised our flag and our hope. They've been called leathernecks. They've been called devil dogs. But above all, they're called Marines.
If you don't build the right deck in the first place, time and weather will just wear it away. So we engineered and treated our LP WeatherBest decking so it looks beautiful, lasts longer, and needs less maintenance. That leaves more time for what you really want to do on a deck. Nothing at all. We're not looking for a genius grant, just ways to make life easier. That's what we do. We make the products that build the homes simply better. LP Building Products. Build with us.
If you owe over $10,000 to the IRS or state, call American Tax Relief for a free consultation. We've helped thousands of Americans settle their tax debt for a fraction of what they owed.
Once we hired American Tax Relief, the IRS stopped contacting us. That was an immediate relief.
And they settled our tax debt for a fraction of what we owed.
If you owe over $10,000 to the IRS or state, we can help you settle for less, maybe a lot less.
Call 800-294-1563 for your free consultation.
Stay in the game with an hour of post-game coverage on NESN.
It's your post-game all-access pass with WB Mason's Extra Innings and Granite City Electric's Extra Innings Extra.
Closed captioning for Red Sox baseball on NESN is brought to you by Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Boston Red Sox baseball on NESN is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, your New England Subaru dealers, Foxwoods Resort Casino, Molson, Verizon, Honda, and by your New England Toyota dealers. Welcome to Fenway Park, night one between the Red Sox and the New York Yankees. And let's send it down to field level and Tina Servasio. Tina?
Don, of course, a special rivalry in sports. And third baseman Mike Lowell has been here in this rivalry in both dugouts. Drafted by the New York Yankees and coming up through their farm system, his very first Major League Baseball game when he was called up in September of 1998 was Red Sox-Yankees. Who did he face? Pedro Martinez was pitching for Boston.
It's definitely a different atmosphere between these two teams, and I think it's great. I mean, the fans get into it. You guys go crazy over it. I mean, it's April, for God's sakes, but I enjoy it. You know, I think it's fun. Every game seems like it's close or something strange happens.
And Mike Lowell said when he came out onto the field, he heard a lot of, let's just say, choice words from the fans here. Of course, he was wearing pinstripes at the time. So he looked over to Luis Soho and said, do we hear this all the time? He says, or is it just once in a while? He says, no. When you're a Yankee and you come into Red Sox Nation, you're going to hear this more than any other place across Major League Baseball. And here we are in it again tonight. Don?
Okay, Tina, thank you very much. Of course, the Red Sox wearing their green jerseys and caps for tonight's game as in memory of the late Red Auerbach, and the Boston Celtics taking part prior to tonight's game in a ceremony as Hall of Famer Bob Cousy threw out the ceremonial first pitch, and of course the Celtics 16 NBA championship banners hung here at Fenway Park, and there's the Cous, who we hope to have on with us a little bit later tonight during the telecast. Great to see him in the behind the back as always. Nicely done. As the Red Sox here tonight take the field in their greens to get ready against the New York Yankees for the first time in 2007. Let's check out the visiting New York Yankees starting lineup brought to you by Rico. Leading it off, Johnny Damon in center field with Derek Jeter at shortstop. Bobby Abreu in right field. Alex Rodriguez at third base with Jason Giambi, the designated hitter. Jorge Posada does the catching. Robinson Cano at second base. Melky Cabrera in left. And Doug Minkiewicz at first base bats ninth. Tonight's starting pitcher is brought to you by Panasonic. And for the Red Sox, it's the ace, Curt Schilling.
After a tough start on opening day for Schilling, back-to-back wins, once against Texas, once against the Angels last time out. 8 innings in the game against the Angels, 4 hits allowed and no runs, 1 walk and 4 strikeouts. See those numbers over the last 2 starts for Schilling. In his career against the Yankees, 7-5 with a 4.44 ERA. That's 19 games and 14 starts against New York. The Red Sox defense is brought to you by your Boston area Lexus dealers. They are 6th in the league with 8 errors in 14 games. Mike Lowell at third base, Julio Lugo the shortstop, Dustin Pedroia at second, and Kevin Youkilis at first, left to right, Manny Ramirez, Coco Crisp, and J.D. Drew. Jason Veritek doing the catching for Schilling.
The umpiring crew tonight, Randy Marsh has a plate, Bob Davidson at first base, Sam Holbrook at second base, and Hunter Wintelstedt, the umpire at third. Where available, this telecast can be heard in Spanish by selecting the SAP button on your television remote. Enjoy the game.
Buenas noches, amigos.
Well, tonight the Red Sox, like the rest of the country, saddened by the events at Virginia Tech, and they are wearing the logos of Virginia Tech on the sleeves and on their caps. And an idea from Jason Veritek and Terry Francona today, and certainly our thoughts and prayers of all of the victims' families. And the flag at half-mast here at Fenway Park as well to begin tonight's ballgame as Johnny Damon stands in on the left side. Here we go, the first of 18 between the Red Sox and the Yankees in the regular season. Damon's ready, Schilling is not. Off the backside for an extra moment. 300 start to the season for Damon with a home run and 5 runs batted in. The first pitch is in there for strike one to Damon. We're underway. The fourth start of the year for Schilling. The only tough one was opening day against Kansas City. Since then, he's been Curt Schilling-like as he pours in another strike, and it's 0-2.
First two pitches to Johnny Damon, the fastball and the cut fastball to quickly get ahead of Damon. And both pitches in tight on Damon.
Damon with a late swing. Of course, fouls off a great many pitches when getting down 0-2.
Yeah, when you're down, no balls, two strikes, you kind of expect the ball either in tight or way away. And that time, Damon got the ball in tight and somehow was able to foul that off.
Derek Jeter waiting on deck. Foul over in his general direction. Given one of the better two-strike hitters in the game. As he chops one off the glove of Schilling out towards Pedroia, the throw in time to get Damon. So Damon is retired. Here comes Derek Jeter. There's been so much talk about A-Rod, but it's been a good start for Derek Jeter also. 323. No homers and four runs batted in for Jeter. He has hit safely in 13 of 14 games this season.
That's really been a good start for this whole offense.
Jeter's hit safely in 39 of his last 41 games dating back to last year. Down from third is Lowell, calling everybody off to secure out number two.
First pitch swinging, Derek Jeter. He gets the fastball inside that ties him up. And a little pop up between home plate and the mound. You see the fastball got up and in on Derek Jeter. You see how he brings his hands in and really gets tied up. And of course, Mike Lowell making the catch at third base.
Two down now for Bobby Abreu. The 345 with a home run and 13 runs batted in. And a great homestand, which the Yankees had a great homestand too. They just swept the Cleveland Indians, and especially yesterday, in dramatic fashion. And Abreu was 8 for 12 in the series, and there is the guy that won it for the Yankees yesterday. It was a collective effort and an amazing comeback. The Yankees entered the bottom of the ninth inning trailing 6-2 with two outs when Josh Phelps got it all started with a solo home run to left, his first home run of the year, and then Posada and Jeter each recorded a ninth inning single extending their respective hitting streaks. And Alex Rodriguez with the game winning three run walk-off home run in the bottom of the ninth. This is to center, sending Chris back onto the track for out number three. 8-pitch, 1-2-3 first for Schilling. Red Sox coming up.
There's an exciting sound in travel. Southwest Airlines, ding. Get exclusive low fares sent directly to your desktop. Deals that are only available for a limited time and only by downloading ding at southwest.com.
To provide comfort as well as confidence. Tenderness as well as technology. Compassion as well as care. To teach as well as touch. To feel safe as well as sound. To hear laughter as well as heartbeats. Maine Medical Center, centered around you.
Catch your Sox round the clock with Sox in 2, presented by T&K Asphalt Services. Tune in game nights at midnight and the next afternoon for 2-hour game replays. Nesson keeps your Sox on with Sox in 2.
Smell that? Ah, new car smell. And in the car sales business, new car smell is like an aphrodisiac to a prospective buyer. It is in the seduction of this fragrant, deep aroma that many salespeople practice the bait and switch. Oh, we don't have that car you saw advertised, but you can buy this one for a whole lot more money.
A quiet first inning for the Yankees as the Red Sox come up in the bottom of the first. And tonight's starting pitcher brought to you by Panasonic for the Yankees in his second stint with the Yankees, Andy Pettitte.
And a very good start for Pettitte. Four games, three starts, the 1-0 record, 1.50 ERA in his career against the Red Sox, 13-5 for Andy Pettitte. Of course, Pettitte last year with the Houston Astros went 14-13. He made 35 starts a year ago for Houston.
Leo Lugo leading it off for Boston in the bottom of the first inning. And Lugo taking the strike. And he's quickly down 0-2.
Red Sox will see the fastball, the breaking ball, the cut fastball, which has always been Pettitte's best pitch, and a changeup.
Lugo 0 for his last 8 in the last two games. Ground at Jeter. Lugo retired for the first out in the bottom of the first. And we check out the rest of the Red Sox starting nine. Brought to you by New England Dodge Dealers. Kevin Yuchel is batting second at first base with David Ortiz, a designated hitter. Manny Ramirez in left. J.D. Drew in right field. Mike Lowell at third base. Jason Veritek doing the catching with Coco Crisp in center. And Dustin Pedroia at second base bats ninth. One down in the inning for Kevin Youkilis. A strike over the inside corner. Youkilis, 1-for-13 in the three-game series against Toronto to drop the average down to 235 from 289. And is 3 for his last 27 on the road. So certainly happy to be back home here at Fenway Park.
Now only two players in the Red Sox lineup tonight have not faced Pettitte. Youkilis being one of them, Dustin Pedroia the other.
Inside and Youkilis gets hit. In on the hands it appeared and he is down.
Well, that'll certainly get the fans going here at Fenway Park. An 0-2 fastball by Andy Pettitte that gets Youkilis, it looks like, right off the hand. Usually when Pettitte comes inside, he comes inside with the cut fastball, not the straight fastball. That was the straight fastball that time.
So the Red Sox have a base runner with one down as Big Poppy stands in. Ortiz at 288, 5 homers and 13 runs batted in. And he has been hot over the last 6 games, 9-for-23. At 391 as he takes a pitch away.
One thing base runners at first base have to remember about Andy Pettitte, he's got one of the best pickoff moves in all of baseball.
Drop by Posada. It's ball two and it's 2-0. No advance for Youkilis at first. Pettitte last year 14-13 with a 4.20 ERA and 35 starts for the Houston Astros. And a single season career high with appearances made 36 appearances a year ago. Falling behind Ortiz 3-0. Joe Torre back at the helm of the New York Yankees. Ball four and a four pitch walk for Big Poppy down to first.
That was interesting. A 3-0 count to David Ortiz. Apparently Pettitte expecting him to have the green light. He stays with the cut fastball on the 3-0 count. So no straight fastball for Ortiz, 3-0.
So the Red Sox with runners at first and second. And a hit batsman and a walk. Two on, one away for Manny Ramirez. A 200 average, a home run, and 8 runs batted in. Manny Ramirez connecting for his first home run of 2007, a game-tying two-run shot in the top of the eighth inning. And it came in his 14th game, 50th at bat of the season. Last year did not go deep for the first time until April 21st, 2 days earlier this season. As he grounds it towards Jeter, the second for one on to first, the double play that ends the inning. So Pettitte works around a hit batsman and a walk. We played one scoreless from Fenway.
When it comes to repairs, VIP always tells you up front what's wrong, when it'll be fixed, and we'll do it for less. At VIP, we shoot straight, always. We'll never leave you in the dark. Our qualified techs will tell you what your car needs and what it doesn't in plain English. Our full one-year nationwide warranty on parts and labor means we stand behind everything we do. And we'll always let you know exactly when your repairs will be done. When you need service, head to VIP. A little love goes a long way.
Like I said, we live in a society where the individual ego and the group dynamic are in constant struggle.
Response?
Yeah, I have a response. What?
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Nobody said this was going to be easy.
Now see, if Geico.com had taken that approach instead of telling everyone it's so easy a caveman can do it, I wouldn't be having an existential meltdown right now.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The import with a taste as big as Canada. Molson Canadian. Here's to good nature.
Have you heard about the benefits of a reverse mortgage? If you're a homeowner, 62 years or older, and would like to supplement your monthly income, a reverse mortgage could be the key to living comfortably in retirement. U.S. government-insured reverse mortgages allow seniors to convert the equity in their home into cash without having to move or make monthly loan payments. We offer a free information kit and video explaining everything you need to know about a reverse mortgage.
Call 800-300-4519.
Well, there are great seats owned by one of the Red Sox partners being auctioned off to benefit the team charity, the Red Sox Foundation. Two EMC club seats in the front row. Please visit RedSox.com to make your bid for a charitable donation and purchase.
On to the second inning. Alex Rodriguez leads it off for the Yankees. That one drops in there for a strike. 14-game hitting streak. He's hit safely in every game so far this season for New York. A .351 batting average, 10 home runs to lead the majors, and of course the 26 RBIs. Hit the walk-off home run, his 10th of the season in the ninth inning. His third home run in the last three games. And the walk-off victory from behind for the Yankees in dramatic fashion. It was the seventh walk-off home run of his career, the fourth as a New York Yankee. But Jerry, as you pointed out in the open tonight, when you talk about Alex Rodriguez, until some of these things take place in the postseason, you get the feeling he would truly not be embraced as a Yankee.
Yeah, he's got him turned around right now. There's no question about that, but it has to continue.
And it evens up now at 2-2.
That's three curveballs that Schilling has thrown in this at bat. Three of the four pitches to A-Rod have been breaking balls, curveballs, and you don't see that very often from Curt Schilling.
Next out, Schilling taking too much time. A-Rod, the first Yankee to hit safely in each of the first 14 games of the season since Scott Brosius did it in 2001. Drives it to center. Crisp is back. This will take him to the dirt of the track, but it's out number one. Red Sox Yankees coverage on Nesson is brought to you by Hess and Hess Express.
Pretty good pitch here by Curt Schilling, but hit very well by A-Rod. It's going to be a fastball away, so he covers the plate and still able to drive it to center field deep, but not deep enough. Coco Crisp there to make the play just in front of the warning track.
Schilling has retired the first four tonight as Jason Giambi stands in. One for four in Thursday's win against Cleveland. Now has four home runs on the season, 255 average and 11 RBIs. Drove in 113 runs in 2006. He takes the strike.
Another curveball from Schilling. A lot of curveballs here early in the ballgame for him. Alex Rodriguez saw three of them. That was the curveball again to Giambi.
Another strike from Schilling, and it's one and two.
Of course, the big shift put on Giambi as Dustin Pedroia well out on that outfield grass in right field. He'll go at shortstop, and of course, Pedroia a good distance from first base.
Some of his 14 hits this season have been to right. This time he goes the opposite way to left, carrying Ramirez back in front of the wall to make the catch. Two down. Third ball to reach the warning track off Schilling in the game, but there's two outs here in the second. He's retired the first five.
Yeah, really no breeze here tonight either. It was a little bit gusty earlier in the afternoon, but right now nothing. Just underneath that fastball is Giambi going the other way. It's going to run Manny right back to the wall to make the play.
Two down here in the top half of the second inning, and it brings up Jorge Posada. Talked about this Yankees offense, which has been working at all cylinders. And he's been as big a part of it as anybody so far this season. Drives it to deep center field as well. Chris back at the track, front of the wall, and again almost to the wall. All three outs are almost to the wall. Inning and a half done, no score.
My neighbor drove all over town to find the best deal on a cell phone. I just logged on to Let's Talk. They make it easy to compare plans from all major carriers and find cell phone deals that are much cheaper than retail.
Like the hot BlackBerry Pearl with music and video player, a $369 value, yours free after mail-in rebate and new calling plan.
Let's Talk has the best prices, the best plans, and the most free phones guaranteed.
Log on to 25letstalk.com or call now to order your BlackBerry Pearl. Let's Talk, the smarter way to shop for cell phones. So log on or call now.
Only Friendly's can make a burger like this and a decadent sundae like this. Come in now and try your favorite, like our Southwestern Bacon Burger, a juicy burger with melted pepper jack, hickory smoked bacon, and our unique chipotle sauce, or the Chicago Firehouse Burger, topped with spicy cherry peppers and fresh red onion. Now get a free happy ending sundae with any featured burger, or try our new Coffee House Turtle Sundae for only $3.99. Friendly's, come for the food, leave room for the ice cream.
Will spin up to 30 times a second and break as much as 17 inches. Watch every pitch in clear Panasonic motion. Panasonic Plasma for the speed of sports. Panasonic, ideas for life.
Hello?
Mrs. Anderson, this is Mark Brown. I'm from the collections department of...
Hi. Listen, I'm sorry I haven't made my payment yet. I'll get it in as soon as I can.
Maybe you should call In Charge. They'll work with you and come up with a solution that's right for you.
When life hands you a little more than you can manage, call In Charge Debt Solutions. We're a nonprofit company that puts people back in control by helping them manage their debt. We'll stop the collection calls, and we'll help lower your interest rates, so you'll have one affordable monthly payment. Call In Charge today.
Grubs, their mission, destroy your lawn.
Now there's Bayer Advanced season-long grub control with Merit. Its exclusive 2-in-1 formula stops grubs all season. Plus, it revitalizes your lawn, guaranteed. Bayer Advanced.
Don't forget, Wednesday is Administrative Professionals Day. Show your gratitude with the help of Sox Appeal's florist of choice, 1-800-Flowers.com. Right now, when you buy a Superstar Banquet of 12 roses, you get 12 free, plus a free vase for just $39.99. And don't miss Sox Appeal, Nesson's whole new take on the dating ball game coming this July.
Last half of the second inning, J.D. Drew swinging through a pitch. Drew, Lowell, and Veritek face Andy Pettitte here in the second inning of the scoreless ball game from Fenway. J.D. Drew off to the 341 start with a home run, 7 runs batted in.
J.D. Drew has had pretty good success against Andy Pettitte, 375 with a couple of home runs. But Pettitte in control here, 0-2.
Drew, Lowell, and Veritek expected here in the bottom of the second inning. Right center and in for a hit. Damon over quickly to play, but Drew aboard with a leadoff single here in the second.
Well, maybe because on the 0-2 count to Euculus, when he came way in and hit him, he didn't get this fastball far enough into J.D. Drew on the 0-2 count. He left it on the inside part of the plate, and Drew picks up the base hit. You know, lefties throughout Pettitte's career have had better success against him. Look at the numbers. 276, righties 266, and I think the reason for that, that cut fastball that bears in on right-handers.
Drew, the leadoff first, held on by Minkiewicz. As Mike Lowell. It's a 280 so far this season. The home run, 9 runs batted in. This hit safely the season high, 5 straight games. His first home run on Wednesday of the season. As this one grounded to short, Jeter will touch second and fire on to first. The Yankees have turned their second double play in as many innings.
Well, the changeup has been the pitch in both times, both occasions that he's got the double play ball on. It was a changeup to Manny Ramirez, and it's a changeup here to Mike Lowell. And both changeups have resulted in double plays against the Red Sox.
This player profile brought to you by Sovereign Bank, the official bank of the Red Sox cable network. 10th season with the Yankees, 2 stints, 287 games, 150 victories for Andy Pettitte. That ranks him as the pitch on the way to Veritek. His ball one to Jason. As far as strikeouts go on the all-time list, Pettitte ranks 5th for the Yankees with 1,285. Jason Lefty Gomez, who occupies 4th place.
It just didn't seem right not to see Pettitte in a Yankee uniform, but down there in Houston, did it?
No, very strange. We're hoping that returning to New York will return to his winning ways. And as this one grounded down to Rodriguez at third, it's an 8-pitch inning for Andy Pettitte. We're through the first two without a score from the fans.
$10,000 to the IRS or state, call American Tax Relief for a free consultation. We've helped thousands of Americans settle their tax debt for a fraction of what they owed.
Once we hired American Tax Relief, the IRS stopped contacting us. That was an immediate relief.
And they settled our tax debt for a fraction of what we owed.
If you owe over $10,000 to the IRS or state, we can help you settle for less, maybe a lot less.
Call 800-294-1563 for your free consultation.
Thank you.
What if everyone checked their washrooms every half hour? Irving does. We inspect and clean our washrooms every 30 minutes. Being obsessed with making things better for you? That's my what if.
This is Table 12 at Carrabba's Italian Grill. It's where our passion for food and people comes together to make great things happen. Table 12 is where girls' night out becomes a great night out. And where sharing your linguine pescatore makes 2 years apart feel like 2 minutes ago.
When people get together over our original family recipes,
good things happen around our table.
New season, new coach. It's time for another year of Boston College football. Jamie Parker sits down for a one-on-one with Coach Jeff Godzinski and catches up with quarterback Matt Ryan before he begins his final season at the Heights. Don't miss the special edition of BC Sports Weekly Spring Football Special tomorrow at noon.
Scoreless as we head to the top half of the third inning. You practiced it a bunch, too.
What did I say?
It's Jagodzinski, right?
Right. You said Jeff Gattazinski. Just call him Coach Jags.
Had a tough time with names over the last couple of days. Some tough ones.
Robinson Cano leads it off. Bottom third of the Yankees order. 18 pitches for Schilling. 14 of them for strikes out of the gate. Cano at 268. It was just a 1-for-11 on the homestand for the Yankees. 0-for-4 yesterday in the final game of the series against the Indians.
That's a straight change from Curt Schilling. Used quite a bit of those in his last outing against the Angels.
Cano taking ball 3-0. 353 for Cano against Curt Schilling. Last year, Cano finished the year hitting a 342. 15 homers and 78 RBIs in 122 games. And there's a strike, 3-1. 342 batting average, third highest for a Yankee in his second season in the majors. According to the Elias Sports Bureau, only Joe DiMaggio and Don Mattingly hitting better. DiMaggio hit 346 back in 1937 and 84. Mattingly hitting at 343. To left field, sinking fast. Ramirez will play it on a hop. He goes into the tumble, and it's the first base runner of the night for the Yankees. A leadoff single for Robinson Cano.
Abel and Manny playing very shallow, can't quite get to this one as he sees the backhand and it bounces on the grass before heading into the glove, but almost made a terrific play on that because he does play shallow in left field.
The lead runner on for the Yankees, and here's Melky Cabrera. And 204, no homers and 4 runs batted in. Cabrera, of course, seeing time with Hideki Matsui on the disabled list for the Yankees. Of course, did a lot of that last year, and Matsui was injured, fracturing his wrist against the Red Sox. Matsui, incidentally, scheduled to make a rehab appearance with the Class A Tampa tonight. He was placed on the 15-day DL on the 8th of April with a strained left hamstring. He was injured while running out of ground ball in the second inning of the game against the Baltimore Orioles. So he is on the DL for the second time in his career, something that is very strange for him. You got to remember that Matsui played 518 consecutive games to start his major league career before fracturing the wrist last year and injured again this season for Joe Torre.
For a non-winning $5 and $10 Red Sox instant tickets from the Mass Lottery into cash with every Red Sox victory in the $1 million double play. Learn how to play at masslottery.com, and once you've entered, check the site after every Red Sox victory to see if you're a winner.
2-1 the count to Melky Cabrera. Lead off first base for Cano. Center field falling fast. This will drop in for a hit in front of Crisp. Up to second goes Cano. And all of a sudden, runners at first and second with nobody out.
Don, you mentioned a lot of the injuries the Yankees have, and they're going to start getting people back very quickly. You mentioned Matt Sui will be returning. Jim Mingguan will be returning as their, actually their ace on this pitching staff. Mike Messina also should be back very shortly. We don't know about Pavano. And Jeff Parsons with the elbow problem will be back tomorrow as he is making the start here at Fenway Park. So a lot of those guys who have been injured should be back within the next week or two.
Well, Chin Ming Wong made his second rehab start with the Class A Tampa on Thursday. This is the bunt bid by Minkiewicz. Schilling looked towards third but fires to first. And Minkiewicz retired, but he gets the job done. The runners move along on the sacrifice.
The nice job by Minkiewicz in bunting down that third baseline, pulling Lowell off the bag. And of course, when Schilling feels it, there's nobody at the third base bag. So the only play is to first base. And the Yankees get two men in scoring position. In Minkiewicz, they pick up a number 9 hitter and a very good defensive first baseman, as we know from his time here in Boston.
Yeah, only Travis Lee among active first basemen have a better fielding percentage. You know all about Doug Minkiewicz and his fine defense. And as Damon stands in for the second time against Schilling, grounded out to second base, first time up. And Schilling starts off ahead. Damon becoming the fourth player in Yankees franchise history to hit at least 20 home runs and steal 20 bases in his first season with the Yankees. Joining A-Rod, Ricky Henderson, and Bobby Bonds, all who did it prior to Johnny Damon.
Now Schilling thought he had strike two here against Damon, a cut fastball, but did not call by Randy Marsh. It's the same way he started Damon in his first at bat. Fastball, then cut fastball.
On the ground towards Lugo. He'll look towards the plate, but fire to first for the out that he could get. The Yankees will pull ahead 1-0. Damon retired, but he picks up his 6th RBI of the season, and the Yankees strike first.
Of course, at this stage of the ball game, Red Sox playing that infield back, and the only option for Lugo. He took a peek at third base, had no chance there to get Cabrera, so he gets Damon at first. Yankees pick up the first run. There's the look at third. No chance at third base. Get the sure out at first.
So two down, Melky Cabrera at third base as Derek Jeter stands in. Swing and a miss for Jeter. Jeter popping out to the third baseman Mike Lowell, his first time up. Jeter coming in with a 10-game hitting streak into tonight's action. Sits safely in all but one game this season, 13 out of the first 14. Of course, finishing second in the American League MVP voting last year to Justin Morneau. And winning his third consecutive Gold Glove Award. Outside, 2-1 now to Jeter.
Hardest fastball that Schilling has thrown tonight at 93 miles an hour, but just outside and falling behind 2-1.
The Abreu waits on deck, two down here in the top of the third. Melky Cabrera at third base. Larry Boa over his shoulder, the third base coach. On the outside corner again. And it evens up at 2-2. Jeter with words for Randy Marsh.
Yeah, I'm not happy about that call. It seemed like the pitch before was almost in the same spot. This time it's more of a cut fastball, as you can see, by Schilling. This time Marsh calls it a strike. Well, it's kind of a guessing game on that outside part of the plate right now.
Schilling Schilling gets the sign from Verachek, glanced at third, the 2-2. A full count now to Jeter. Two pitch. Ball four, he walks him, and the first base on ball surrendered by Schilling. Boston Red Sox baseball in Netson is brought to you by Half Lap, Olympia Sports, the official sporting goods retailer of the New England Sports Network, and by Dunkin' Donuts. Two down here in the top half of the third inning. The Yankees have drawn first blood as they have the 1-0 advantage, looking for more with runners at first and third and two down. And Abreu with some timely hitting so far in the season, 4-for-7 in this situation. It's the strike. He started off slowly this season, of course, suffering a strained right oblique muscle at the start of spring training and missed the first 3 weeks of the spring. Didn't see his first action of spring training till the last week of March. Walks a ton. He led the majors with 124 walks last year and has reached the 100 walk plateau in 8 consecutive seasons. So to say that he is patient is probably an understatement. Becoming the only third player in Major League history to do so. 8 consecutive seasons of 100 plus. Base on balls. And the 40th pitch of the contest for Curt Schilling with two outs in the third. Abreu is first time up. Sent one to the warning track in center field, retired by Coco Crisp. Swing and a miss, 2-2. Splitter that time from Schilling. Splitter that stays inside. Usually it goes down and away. You see Verachek on the outside part of the plate, but that ball stayed inside. Having to expend his most energy so far here in the third. Did he hold up? Went around, rung up by Hunter Winnelstad, third base umpire. He is dismayed, but he's out number three. Yankees take a 1-0 lead.
The weather was so much better yesterday.
A bad day in Florida beats a good day almost anywhere else. With over 80 daily flights from Manchester and Providence to the Sunshine State, Southwest Airlines is taking low fares farther.
You are now free to move about the country.
Smell that? Ah, new car smell. And in the car sales business, new car smell is like an aphrodisiac to a prospective buyer. It is in the seduction of this fragrant, deep aroma that many salespeople practice the bait and switch. Oh, we don't have that car you saw advertised, but you can buy this one for a whole lot more money.
Olympia Sports is your majestic headquarters, featuring the new thermoplastic technology that insulates while maintaining temperature control. Get it at Olympia Sports. Shop with confidence, satisfaction guaranteed.
What does it take to earn AMCI's best-in-class certification for acceleration? Raw horsepower. The all-new, full-size Toyota Tundra. The truck that's changing it all.
Last half of the third inning, the Yankees have struck first. They lead 1-0 as we head to the last half of the third. Coco Crisp, Dustin Pedroia, and Julio Lugo face Andy Pettitte, who surrendered his first hit last inning to J.D. Drew. It is an honor to have Hall of Famer Bob Cousy in the booth with us. We hope you'd come up, and glad you did. Great to see you.
Thank you, guys. As long as there was an elevator, I was going to make it. If it had been steps, I'm afraid you'd have to wait a while.
Well, a great first pitch and a great ceremony here tonight to honoring Red Auerbach.
Absolutely. All of us with the Celtics were very pleased to see that acknowledgement. You know, and obviously, we feel it couldn't happen to a more deserving guy.
Well, you look at the two of the greatest franchises in the history, and the Yankees, of course, here in baseball, and the Celtics, as we look at all the flags, and of course, Bob throwing out the first pitch. Not a bad first pitch.
You're very kind, yeah. I practiced yesterday, you know. As soon as Heather called me, I got on the phone and got a couple of high school kids, Matt Lynch and Dan Conrad, and they came over with their gloves, and we stood outside. People going by in the street and say, "What's that old man doing out there?" You know, playing catch with a bunch of kids. But anyway, when it was warmer, I got it over the plate. Today, I almost got it home.
And I liked the behind-the-back pitch too.
Yeah,
that was pretty good.
That was one for the ages, I guess.
A few degrees warmer, and you would have gotten it there. I know you would have.
Once a show off, always a show off. Right?
Well, I know you have a great many memories of Red, and certainly we've heard so many great Celtics over the years, but a great loss.
It was. You know, I used to kid him and say, "You're too mean. You're going to outlive us all," you know. But he was ready. I was very pleased to have gotten the opportunity to be with him 3 days before he passed. He was honored by the United States Navy in Washington, and we flew down. And so, but, you know, I hadn't seen him in some months, and when Nancy, his daughter, brought him in a wheelchair, I hugged Nancy and we both started bawling because he looked that bad. So it was time, but obviously a wonderful, productive, you know, spectacular career in sports.
Well, Bob, teams that win over and over again with the same coach, what made him different than everybody else? How did he motivate you guys year after year to be the best?
You know, like everything else, it followed the money trail. You know, I mean, I was the highest paid player in the year in the league my last year. I made $35,000.
Wow, big bucks.
There weren't any long-term contracts. There was any. And we were all ghetto kids, you know. We came out of those ghettos with the saliva dripping down, saying "kill." And Arnold was from a ghetto in Brooklyn. So, you know, in those days, motivation ended up to be fear and intimidation. You know, when a coach screamed at you, you listened and then you performed. But what I'm most proud about, and I think what Arnold has left to the fans in New England, really. I mean, It's a wonderful area, as we all know, for sports. And the Red Sox, the Bruins, the Patriots have all given their fans proud, proud moments they'll be able to live their golden years with. But Arnold gave them, I think, something special, you know, for the fans, their kids, their grandkids. Records are made to be broken, I understand that. This one will stand forever. 11 championships in 13 years. You'll never see that kind of domination. So we New England fans will be able to brag about that for a long time. And he was the architect. He was the man. He put it together. He knew talent, knew how to acquire it, knew how to motivate it, and as he did for year after year. You know. So it was a wonderful time to be in sports in Boston.
This one has popped up on the move. Is Posada, and he'll reel it in for out number two.
I got a tough question for you. The Celtics, of course, will have an excellent opportunity to get number one. And of course, you for many years played with Bill Russell, who, well, what can you say about Bill Russell?
He's the best center that's ever played, I think.
So now you got Oden coming out, and you maybe have Durant coming out. You got both those guys. What would be your choice for the Celtics?
Yeah, they probably need Oden more than Durant, although Durant is a more complete player and he's ready to go now, Jeff. From what little I've seen, you know, you watch on television and I'm out of the loop. I'm down in Florida teaming up, so I don't get to see these guys as often as I don't like to. But Durant's ready to play. They claim he has defensive liabilities. However, you know, no one on the Celtics taught him up defensively this year, so he might fit right in. The other kid, however, probably they would need more. And he has amazing athletic qualities, but his offense, I'll tell you, is 2 or 3 years away.
Yeah,
from what I've seen.
He's still growing. I mean, he's just a kid.
Yeah, oh, absolutely. And yeah, his first year. It's coming out his first year. So I would hope, I would, you know, Ivan would be the guy, but I'll tell you, in sports, you guys know it, when it comes to draft choices and getting something, when you want something very badly, it never happens, you know. God, it's like, and Arnold, for 35 years, 50 to about 86. He was not only good and smart, but he was extremely fortunate, too. Every move he made turned to gold. Poor Lenny Bias goes himself there in 86, and ever since then, everything that's happened, you know, it's like sitting in a poker game where you can't get a losing hand, and all of a sudden, wow, the momentum turns, and you can't do anything with it. And that's been the Celtic lot for 20 years now. Everything, so I'm keeping my fingers crossed. They're sending my friend Heinsohn down for a good luck charm. So let's hope Tommy does his magic down there. But Ogden would be, Odin would be the guy.
Yeah, I kind of figured he'd be leaning that way. With all the years you play with Russell, with the big man, and you know, he's a shot blocker. And of course, Russell was the best in the business at that. So,
well, they're one player away, I think, from being competitive, not putting up another flag. I think I'd rather see them get the big kid than the forward, although the forward's going to be a player as well.
I remember talking to Danny Ainge early in the season, before it even started, actually, over at where the Celtics work out, and he said, you know, we've got a lot of guys who are very good AAA players who are just starting to get there.
Well, Danny's been criticized for going with youth and draft choices. And I'll tell you, I watched Rick Pitino here for 3 years. He went the other way. He made, I think, 101 deals, if you can believe it, in 3 or 4 years, you know, trying to find the instant answer. And I don't think it works that way. I'd rather, frankly, be doing what Danny's doing and have confidence in your draft picks, develop them, bring them along, and hope you've made the right decisions, you know. Every now and then throw a free agent in there, but
I kind of had that feeling when I was listening to you about Pitino. I didn't think he was one of your favorites.
Well, he's a hell of a coach. I don't misunderstand me, but I think he's where he belongs. I think on a college level, I think he tried to bring the his college full court extended press, etc., into the pros, and they just do it too often to sustain the kind of pressure you need to have that be successful. So, he's a good coach. His style in terms of building, you know, a unit, I just don't think you can do it. There's just not enough talent out there. They've watered down the leagues, and you start making trades, you can do it forever, as you've been.
Bob, with all the championships you won, is there one team that sticks out in your mind as being your favorite?
Well, the first one was the sweetest, but especially for me, you know, when you're trying to grab the brass ring for 6 years and you're unsuccessful and then you finally get it. Russell and Heinsohn, they think, that's all they did was win. They thought, well, you're supposed to lose and then you win a championship every year, you know. But I guess I appreciate it more because we had a lot of frustration for 6 years. I think the best one was maybe the 61 or 60 team when we had 4 Hall of Famers in the backcourt. Myself and Bill Sharman were still with us, and Casey and Sam backing us up. I think Gene Conley backing up Russ, and Satch and Rams, and I think that, in my judgment, was the best team that's ever been put together.
That's pretty deep.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, we had 11 guys that could all play, and I think we ran 8 Hall of Famers through the unit at that point, so we had a lot of power.
Evan Yuko's batting here with 2 down. Julio Lugo had walked. He stands at first base. Pettit's ahead 0-2. Yukalis down the line, but foul outside the bag. Close, but a foul ball.
Do you get to watch much baseball?
I watch it, yeah. I years ago, I stopped going places where there are a lot of people. I'm a loner, I guess. So.
You and Jerry have a lot in common.
Especially when it comes to parking and try to be 78. Where did you that age? See how much patience you have with anything. All the creature comforts we get used to, you know. And God, I don't even want to wait at a red light. So yeah, I avoid 35,000 people if I can. But no, what else do we do? We watch the tube and obviously follow the Sox. Your eminent producer, Mr. Ken.
He's
old and dear friend. A kid who played for me at BC, Bobby Furbush. I think he's still with the ticket office.
Yes.
Has been for years. So there's, and Larry, believe it or not, he came up to me at a Jimmy Fund function 2 years ago and introduced himself and said, "You don't remember me, do you?" I said, "Larry, I don't remember who I met yesterday, so don't feel bad." He said, "I went to your camp 2 years in a row." We had a boys' camp for 20 years in New Hampshire. And Larry was one of the little dribblers around there.
I think he was a Princeton?
Princeton, yeah.
In fact, one of the Celtics then is Bobby Epstein, who was at our camp for a couple of years too, so we groomed him.
Lucas with a lengthy at bat here against Andy Pettitte as they check it first. Lugo back to the bag at first.
Now, we're very fortunate because we get to work with Russ Kent too, you know, so this is like a big highlight to for Russ. You worked many years with him.
Yeah, he just wouldn't give you enough on a golf course. he was tough to negotiate with. Young and strong, hit the ball a mile and wouldn't give me a stroke out there.
Euclid's on the ground, left side. Jeter deep in the hole, turns and fires. No chance. As Lugo in the second base, Euclid's reaching. Bob Cousy, thanks for joining us. Great to see you.
Thank you very much. Pleasure. Really enjoyed it.
Good. Thank you very much.
Appreciate it, my friend.
Well, the Red Sox here with two outs in the inning all of a sudden have runners at first and second.
Too far to go for Derek Jeter in the hole. Good battle by Euclid in that at bat. He'll try the force at second base, but of course with Lugo there, too much speed and they can't get the force. So the inning stays alive to get to Ortiz.
Forty pitches now for Pettitte. He's had to work a little harder here in the third. Ortiz with a swing and a miss.
Big slow breaking ball from Pettitte to quickly get ahead of David Ortiz. Remember last time up on the 3-0 count, he threw in the cut fastball.
20 pitches through the first two. He's thrown 21 pitches alone here in the third. Lugo at second, Euclid at first, two down. Up top, 90 from Pettitte, 1-1. Big Poppy walked his first time up. One of two walks tonight allowed by Andy Pettitte. Ground with the shift on. Cano in short right throws out Ortiz to end the inning. The Red Sox grand 2-1 New York. Time for a Sports Desk update with Hazel Mann.
Don, thank you. Hi, everybody. Celtics point guard Sebastian Telfair is facing felony and misdemeanor charges after a run-in with New York police. We'll tell you what happened early Friday morning that's got him in a heap of trouble. That's tonight on Sports Desk, presented by FW Web, home of Frank Webb's Bass Centers. I'll see y'all later tonight. Back to Fenway Park after this break in the action.
I don't know what you can depend on.
I chose my loyalty.
Everything comes to an end.
The Sopranos, the final season. And the only place to see it is HBO. Order HBO now from Time Warner Cable to get it all. And go to Roadrunner.com for extras that take you inside The Sopranos. It all comes together on HBO from Time Warner Cable.
Call Time Warner Cable today for special savings on digital cable, HBO, and Roadrunner High Speed Online.
We love Darlings.
We love Darlings.
Two family names on the road in Maine for over a century are Ford and Darlings.
They're wonderful people.
Where the value is real.
The Ford Challenge is find out for yourself. There's no better choice than Ford.
They will work with you.
It's like having family in the business.
The countdown is on till the end of the month.
Darlings has the lowest price.
And we welcome all credit scores at Darlings Ford.
The 2007 Chevy Impala LT gets an EPA estimated 31 miles per gallon highway. And now every Impala comes with something Honda and Toyota don't. The best coverage in America. Exhilaration meets sophistication. Qualified lessees can get a low mileage lease on an 07 Impala LT for around $209 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details. See for yourself. Shop and compare at maindrivechevy.com.
From the top nine countdown of all things Sox this week, don't miss Granite City Electric Ultimate Red Sox Show. Hazel May takes a look at everything Sox on and off the field. Check it out this Sunday and every Sunday at 12:30 right here on Nessie.
Well, the Yankees on top 1-0 as we head to the top half of the fourth inning. Andy Pettitte getting out of a bit of a jam in third. Got Ortiz to ground into the ship. Schilling returns to the mound. 42 pitches so far tonight for Schilling. Alex Rodriguez swings through the first one. He sent one to the warning track in center field that Coco Crisp made a catch on. He's got 10 home runs on the season. The Yankees so far as a team 8-1. When he homers as he sends one to deep left back towards the monster seats and gone. Alex Rodriguez continues his torrid pace and beginning the 2007 as he strikes his 11th home run of the year.
Well, remember the first at bat. It was a lot of curveballs early in the count against Rodriguez. This time back-to-back fastballs and boy is he zoned in. I mean, these are the kind of things that are happening to a player you can only dream of. And he had that first fastball the first time up pretty well at center field, this time into the monster seats.
Well, the leadoff home run for Rodriguez. Here's Jason Giambi. Giambi hit one to the warning track and left his first time up. What an amazing run for A-Rod this season. Sorry to say the Yankees are 8-1 when he homers in a game so far this season. Numbers go on and on for Alex Rodriguez.
You know, just watching some tape of him in the early season and of course to here tonight, his balance at the plate just looks so much better than it did a year ago. He looks so comfortable at home plate.
Maybe chopping it off his foot foul.
I was asking around prior to the game, those who follow the Yankees, John Flaherty here doing the game for the YES Network tonight, and he mentioned that his leg kick is not quite as high this year as it was a year ago. And of course if it's not as high, you know, your eyes don't move quite as much, you have better balance. But I'm sure it's just more than that. Still has that leg kick, but you see the weight stays back instead of coming forward. I mean, he just in perfect position to hit when he lands on that front foot.
Grounding another foul, still 1-2. We're here at Fenway Park in Boston. Don Orsillo, Jerry Remy, and Tina Sebastia bringing you Boston Red Sox baseball in high definition and a Dolby Digital 5.1 surround sound on Nesson. The first of 18 meetings between the Red Sox and the New York Yankees. The Red Sox have had the misfortune of losing 7 straight home games to the Yankees here at Fenway Park. Last win for the Red Sox, May 22nd of last year, and Curt Schilling was the winner as he strikes out Giambi's second K for Schilling.
Both strikeouts for Schilling on the split-fingered fastball. He got Abreu to end the third inning, and now the splitter here for the strikeout against Giambi. Well, yeah, the five wins last year here at Fenway put the Red Sox to sleep for the rest of the season.
That effectively ended the season for the Red Sox.
That was it. It was a trip to the West Coast, and once that was over, it was a long final month of the season.
We mentioned Joe Torre back at the helm. And he's not. It's going to seem strange after all this time in his 12th season as the manager of the Yankees. The longest interrupted tenure of any Yankees manager since Casey Stengel, skipper of the club for 12 consecutive seasons from 1949 through 1960. Only the third manager in Major League history to win 90 or more games 10 times in an 11-year span, joining John McGraw, Casey Stengel, I previously mentioned, and Bobby Cox. In a long run, but who knows? This is the last year of his current contract. He said he'd like to stay here beyond this year. But it'll be interesting to see whether that happens or not. And largely, that may depend on how far the Yankees go this season. As it has been a while for the Yankees, they've had some great runs, winning the division a bunch, but that's not what they come for. They come for championships, and it has been a long spell. The rumors flying really about who would replace Joe Torre. Many think, well, first and foremost, it may be his new bench coach and the birthday boy today, 46-year-old Don Mattingly, turns 46 today. His name has been mentioned. He's been quite clear that he would like to manage someday, just does not want to do it now. But would like to manage, but thinks that Joe Torre should be here for the foreseeable future. He was the hitting coach here for the last few years in New York, but moved to the bench coach this season.
Well, you know, Joe has been very popular, of course, with Yankee fans, and for good reason. And if he did decide not to return to the Yankees, Yankee fans would certainly welcome Don Mattingly, because he's always been a very popular Yankee.
Down the line and in for a hit. Manny will chase it to the corner, able to play it barehanded, but into second base with a one-out, well-placed double goes Jorge Posada.
Again, that curveball from Curt Schilling, which was effective for him in the first couple of innings. This time, Posada slicing it down that left field line. Not quite up in the stands, but off the wall. Manny gets it back in, and the double for Posada. So another Yankee in scoring position.
One down, Posada at second, and brings up Robinson Cano. On the ground, down the first baseline, Youkilis will take it himself for the out. Two down, but Posada's on to third.
F.W. Webb is proud to be the official supplier of plumbing, heating, and cooling supplies for the Boston Red Sox. To learn more about how F.W. Webb can help you, contact your local professional contractor or visit fwweb.com. F.W. Webb, we've got it.
So two down, Posada 90 feet away, and it brings up Melky Cabrera. And a single to center field his first time up, one of four Yankees hits. Mentioned the Yankees winning seven straight games here at Fenway Park. Last win for the Red Sox, May 22nd of last year, Schilling on a 9-5 victory. As this one popped up foul off to the left. Last year, the Yankees winning the overall season series 11-8. And of course, after the three games this weekend, they'll play again next weekend at Yankee Stadium. Getting ahead 0-2. There doesn't chase up top 1-2. Schilling about to throw his 60th pitch of the night with 3 2/3 innings. Lifts a fly ball at Coco Crispin Center for the final out. In the top half of the fourth inning, Alex Rodriguez leads it off with a home run that puts the Yankees on top 2-0.
For the the past 30 years, we've been delivering F-Series trucks with unbelievable capabilities. Trucks that can haul over 24,000 pounds. Trucks that give you best-in-class payload. Trucks you depend on to get the job done. No wonder F-Series is the undisputed leader. Now get 0% financing for 60 months or up to $3,500 in total rebates.
Our sauce fresh all day, so dishes like our penne puttanesca are delicious all the time. Bertucci's, what's not to love?
I am your idea. I gotta fly. I gotta move. I'm out of the box and in the network. In the zone and on your mind. Don't stop me now. Give me Rico. Rico's always ready to move me. Send me. Here, there, everywhere. This is how we go. Let's go. Rico.
You are our neighbors. You teach. You cheer. You sacrifice. You help those around you. You love your little corner of the world. Here at Extra Mart, we are proud to serve you, and we thank you for letting us be a part of your community.
Visit the new extramart.com and sign up for the Extra Email Club and have a chance to win a PlayStation 3. Club members are the first to learn about great context, incredible sales, receive coupons, and more. Go to extramart.com today.
Stay tuned all season for the Bob Stores Easy is 1-2-3 strikeout at Bob Stores. They're all about making your shopping experience easy. So this season, make Bob Stores your destination for casual wear, active wear, team wear, and work wear.
Two to nothing now, Yankees on top as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. A change for New York. They've got a new catcher. Will Nieves is into the game. And Jorge Posada comes out. Not sure what happened to Posada. He doubled in that inning and was left at third base to end the inning and has not come back out to catch. So we will look for a further report from the press box as we head to the fourth, and Manny leads it off.
Watch Posada now, the base hit down the left field line. Let's see if any kind of limp happens when it comes along as a second base. It doesn't appear like it's anything major. But Posada leaving the ball game, and Nieves now in there.
Ramirez, Drew, and Lowell to bat here in the bottom of the fourth inning. And he grounded into a 6-4-3 double play in the first inning. The key matchup is brought to you by Killian's. And against Pettitte, three home runs. 417 average, and that includes grounding into the double play in the first inning. Three call. Manning strikes out. It's the second strike after Andy Pettitte. One down in the fourth.
Well, Manny in his career, as we highlighted, great success against Pettitte. That's the fastball outside corner for the strikeout. It was a changeup in the first inning to get Manny to ground into the double play. So Pettitte right on target early in this ball game.
One down for J.D. Drew, who singled to center field his first time up, one of only two Boston hits so far tonight. Jerry, want to send along a speedy recovery to 13-year-old John Shea, who was released from Children's Hospital today after a few surgeries. All our best to John. He's a huge Red Sox fan, especially a big fan of Big Poppy. So get well soon, John. We're all thinking of you. Two 2-0 the count to J.D. Drew. The 50th pitch of the night for Andy Pettitte. And it's cued foul off the end of the bat. And a chance here for J.D. Drew to get his feet wet in this great rivalry. Baseball's best, the Red Sox and Yankees. There's his career in the National League and part of some of the Dodgers rivalries, but I can promise you there's nothing like this, and I'm sure he's feeling it.
Now both managers, Terry Francona, Joe Torre, both downplaying, obviously, this first series between the Red Sox and the Yankees. 19 times they'll meet. Joe saying that regardless of what happens this weekend, nobody's going to be out of the race. A lot of baseball left to be played.
And I think you'll agree that it almost becomes an annoyance, at least what we see on a daily basis for Terry Francona.
Well, for managers, yeah, because, you know, that's all they talk about leading up to the series. And quite honestly, managers are thinking about the game they're playing that day. Yesterday, he's thinking about Toronto, and once the Yankees leave, he'll be thinking about Toronto again.
To right field, Abreu is deep, comes on, plays it on a hop. He tried to sell it, but out went Bob Davidson to make the correct call, and it's a one-out single for J.D. Drew.
Boy, that's almost identical to Manny's play earlier in the ballgame. Both nice efforts by Ramirez and now Abreu, but not quite in time as the ball first hits the grass, then into that big glove of Bobby Abreu. He does bring it up to try to sell it to the umpire, but Davidson was not buying it. Get a good look at it. Didn't he supposed to do run out as close to the play as possible? But you know something, Don? The players can't help but getting a little bit more excited. Not because it's everything that surrounds it. You know, the reaction from the fans. It's always different when it's a Boston New York game.
Well, from the manager's standpoint, as you pointed out, I mean, they got to worry about that day. And it starts, like, for instance, when we got to Toronto, there were three New York writers already there getting ready for their Yankee previews. And, of course, Terry's getting ready for Roy Halladay and the rest of the Toronto Blue Jays in the three-game series, which is certainly a battle against the Jays. And their focus certainly just on this weekend and this series. So for the manager trying to worry about that game, it's troublesome, but he did a very good job, I thought, handling a lot of the New York writers. So off goes Drew on the first pitch, and he is going to be very out at second base. Wilner Yevis throws him out, two down.
Well, we mentioned Pettitte has one of the best pickoff moves, and that's a very late start by J.D. Drew, and you'd have to wonder, was there a sign miss? Was that a possible hit and run put on? I don't know. I'd be very surprised down 2-0, but see Drew looking in almost like he was expecting a hit and run. I have a feeling someone may have missed a sign.
Roll drives one towards the wall and off the scoreboard. Hit so hard, now he will turn and stop at first base. And a long single for Mike Lowell.
You know, getting back to that caught stealing, when you don't have a good jump, and certainly J.D. Drew did not have a good jump, and he knew it, but still continued to go, it leads you to believe that maybe there was a play on. I mean, watch how late he gets started towards second base. I mean, Pettit's throwing the ball home, but he's peeking in like he's expecting a swing from Mike Lowell. No swing, and he's out by a long margin at second base. So I don't think that was a straight-out steal.
Well, highlighted by the hit now by Mike Lowell, who stands at first base with two down. Here's Jason Veritek. Jason grounded out to third base, his first time up. Just two for his last 18 over the last five games. The average dropping from 250 to 189.
Get the Sunday Globe's award-winning sports coverage every week. Call 800-984-5335 today for 50% off home delivery. The Boston Sunday Globe start the week off right.
Veritek hoping that returning to Fenway will get the bat going. Of course, it was in the home opener that he enjoyed his best game of the year offensively. Against the Seattle Mariners, 3-for-4 with 3 RBIs.
Coming into the game, Veritek 4-for-7 from the right side, 3-for-30 from the left side.
to deep right field. Abreu headed back towards the track at the wall. It's gone into the bullpen. The captain has tied the game at two.
There's something you don't see very often. Jason Veritek is a right-handed hitter hitting a home run to the opposite field. That looked like it might have been a cut fastball that stayed out over the plate, and Veritek into the Red Sox bullpen. So more success hitting right-handed, and that quickly the game is tied.
Well, Coco Crisp, a big swing and a miss. 2 for his last 17 coming into that at bat, and a two-run home run. And it's now 2-1.
One more look at the Jason Veritek inside out swing to the opposite field. That swing keeps his head down in the ball as long as possible, almost sees contact.
13 home runs for the Red Sox, the first of the year for Jason Veritek. Sox with 13 homers, the Yankees with 21 now on the season. And a strike to Crisp, and it's a full count. Red Sox with at least a home run in the last 7 games straight. A foul outside of third.
Veritek's always had high numbers, high batting average against Pettitte. 361 coming into the game, but that's his first home run against Andy Pettitte.
Chop left side, Jeter with the backhand. Crisp is gone, and so are the Red Sox, but not before Jason Veritek ties the game at two.
When your kids get what they want, you'll get what you want. Now at the Dodge National Minivan Sale, get a factory-installed rear seat DVD player at no extra charge, plus a cash allowance of $4,000 on America's best-selling minivan, Dodge Grand Caravan, with 2 rows of stow-and-go seats. Your kids will thank you, and you'll thank us. Discover America's hottest products at your Dodge dealer.
Follow the curving Irish lanes long enough, and you'll find yourself in the town of Wicklow. And if you arrive on that most special day in Ireland, you'll find the town celebrating their favorite holiday in traditional fashion.
For our fuel comes from oil in the ground. A lot of it comes from our people, who year in and year out put so much of their energy into everything they do. So you can be sure that when you put Valero gas into your tank, you're going to get a lot out of it. Valero, the energy to take you anywhere.
Hey, Les.
What's up? It's Tom.
Hi, Vince.
It's Tom.
Hi, Dave.
Felipe.
Hi, Xavier.
Hello, Terry.
Hey, Floyd.
What up, Steve-O?
What up, Ken?
How's it going, Jebediah?
It's Tom.
Double brewed iced coffee in your favorite flavors, served just the way you like it. Come on, who knows you better than Dunkin' Donuts?
America runs on Dunkin'.
Enjoy a new Berry Berry donut and a Berry Berry flavored iced coffee. It's a combination of raspberry and blueberry.
Back at Fenway, new ball game. Red Sox have tied the score 2-2 as we head to the top half of the fifth. And Doug Mankiewicz, Johnny Damon, and Derek Jeter expected in the inning. Mankiewicz signing a one-year contract as a free agent in this past offseason, the first week of January. Mankiewicz spending last year with Kansas City. And a season with the Mets after leaving Boston after the 2004 championship. Perhaps a lot more heard about Doug Mankiewicz after he left than while he was here in the ball game. Trying to figure out who had the ball, and certainly he wanted it back.
Where is it now, anyway, Don? Yeah, do you have it?
No, I don't have it. I don't think the Red Sox have it either. I think it may be at the Hall of Fame. If I'm
Hall of
mistaken.
Fame?
Yeah. But that was certainly, you know, Keith Folk wanted it. Everybody wanted it.
Well, Folk should have just ran over and tagged for a space. He could have.
He could have. I saw 49 games in a Red Sox uniform, hitting at 215. And some of the fans want the ball to return. Well, he did give the ball back for the time it was what he thought was going to be for a year's time, and then he would get it back, and apparently that was not the case. Ball two, 2-2. In my humble opinion, I think it should either be in the Hall of Fame or in the hands of the Red Sox. If you wait 86 years, you think the club probably deserves that ball a little more than Doug Mankiewicz.
I say for each his own.
The 2-2 was outside ball three.
I don't think Schilling feels quite as comfortable tonight as he did in that last outing against the Angels. He's battling. Just misses the outside corner with the fastball there against Mankiewicz.
In the air out towards deep center field, Coco Crisp headed back towards the track to make the catch. Let's check in with Tina Servasio. Tina.
Don, David Ortiz's autobiography, Big Poppy, My Story of Big Dreams and Big Hits, is on shelves now. David had his first book signing today and gives us a preview of what he has to say in his book about the Yankees rivalry.
Little things happen in the game since way back. It's still happening today, but that is an organization that is professional, just like we are. Remember that in 2004 when we were getting a ring for winning the World Series, see all of them lined up in front of the dugout, clapping for each one of us. That's a thing that you gotta respect that.
For 2 hours today, David signed his name in books for fans. The book was released April 17th, and in just 3 days, it looks like it's already on its way to becoming a national bestseller. Ortiz co-wrote the book with Boston Herald scribe Tony Maserati. It talks about growing up in the Dominican Republic, how his parents raised him, and it gets very personal, too, and he talks about how his mother passed away, and it's in stores now.
Hey, Tina, yeah, I had a chance to read a little bit of it yesterday. You know, get my hands on one of them, and it's a great story. I mean, we all feel like we know Big Poppy, but he really takes you inside in the book. It is a great read, and sure all of Red Sox Nation will get Big Poppy's book. He brought up a great point, I thought, and Damon takes the 0-2 for ball outside. I thought one of the classiest things ever was for Joe Torre and his team to be out there for the entire ring ceremony on opening day 2005 after the championship. And he, like many of the Yankees, on the top step as the players receive their rings. And it slaps it foul, still 1-2. Jeter on deck with one out, bases empty here in the fifth. Strike three call. Schilling strikes out Damon, two down. Ha ha ha.
Cut fastball from Schilling, picks up the inside corner. Damon thought it was inside. Looks like a pretty good pitch. First, the crowd still getting on Johnny Damon. I didn't think the boos were quite as bad in his first at bat as they were a year ago.
No, not close, I don't think. That was unbelievable. And that May 1st game when Damon returned for the first time in a Yankees uniform, and also the same night, it's Degmar Hibeli who returned to the Red Sox in dramatic fashion. It was quite a night, May 1st of last season. Of course, Hibeli making his way across country from San Diego to trade in time to catch Tim Wakefield and the return of Johnny Damon, who was vociferously booed here at Fenway Park in his return. Jerry, you've been here a long time. Do you remember any kind of reception like that for a player who came back? That loud of booze?
I'm trying to think about Roger Clemens the first time he came back, but I don't think it was quite as loud as Johnny. It's the team that he is a team that he had to go to, you know, the Yankees.
So many players have come back since with other uniforms, the Orlando Cabreras of the world. And the reception has been much different.
Yeah, Johnny signed with Kansas City. We got to stand an ovation.
One of the greatest maybe ever that had his problems with the Red Sox. The left field for Derek Jeter, and a two out single for Jeter. The Yankees pick up their fifth hit of the night.
Again, I'm going to mention this is not easy tonight for Schilling. I don't think he feels he has his best stuff. He's trying to battle through this ball game. It's a 2-2 game. There's a splitter that stays up in the zone in, and Jeter picks up the base hit with a couple of strikes on him. It's the kind of game, you know, when you're a veteran pitcher like Schilling, and the, you know, you don't have your best stuff, but you try to find a way to get through it. You know, and he's doing that right now. We're a younger pitcher. Maybe he wouldn't be out here this long.
There are virtually no easy outs in this lineup, you know, on a normal day. If you got Hideki Matsui in there especially. But this is not an easy lineup in any stretch of the imagination. There are no breathers in this lineup as you go from Abreu to A-Rod. Just gave up the hit to Jeter. Abreu is 0-for-2 tonight. He has fly to the track in center and struck out swinging. Giambi in the hole. And on and on. Outside for a ball. And it is 2-0. Schilling wanted it. Not getting the response he wanted from Randy Marsh.
He's had a couple of long looks in at Randy Marsh in this ball game tonight. There was something said by Schilling, and then Marsh responded by emphatically putting up the two ball no strike count with the hands.
Vertek out to help Schilling calm down here a little bit as Randy Marsh looks on. Well, a good one so far here tonight. A 2-2 ball game into the fifth. Jerry, is always so much buildup to a lot of these games, and quite frankly, a lot of these games are not great games when these two teams get together. But tonight, so far, a great one, tied 2-2. We've seen some lopsided battles, they're not living up to the hype, but so far, this one's been a dandy. Toss to first, and Jeter back on the bag.
One steal this year for Jeter, but he has been caught twice. Usually Jeter has an excellent percentage as far as base stealing goes.
I'm sure the Red Sox and the Yankees had 3 1-run games. Abreu lines it to right. Deep was Drew. It's in for a hit. Jeter up to second. And all of a sudden the Yankees have something going here with two down.
Yep, the two-out base hit by Jeter on a splitter. A base hit now by Abreu on a fastball from Schilling. And that brings the hottest man in the world to the plate, A-Rod. The league leaders are brought to you by Olympia Sports. Well, this is a pretty amazing stat. Since 1996, there's only one RBI between A-Rod and Ramirez difference. And that RBI is the home run that Alex Rodriguez hit in his last at bat in the fourth. The home run, his 11th of the season and just his 15th game of the year. And at the time, put New York on top, 2-0. Since then, Jason Varitek has tied the game 2-2. Strike now to A-Rod with two outs in the inning. Well, two outs and runners in scoring position, and it's been amazing. Four home runs, 11 RBIs, and six tries in this tight situation. Jeter and Abreu aboard. Schilling's ahead 1-2. That was 94. And Varitek will head out.
And that fastball was supposed to be away. You're going to see Varitek set up away, but the ball runs back inside. Still no contact by Rodriguez. So a case where Schilling misses his spot, but still gets away with the pitch. And as usual, with a couple of strikes, Varitek out to talk to Schilling and see what he wants to do with the two strikes on Rodriguez.
All this coming with two outs in the inning after Schilling got Minkiewicz to fly out, Damon to strike out, Jeter and Abreu with singles. Two down and the 1-2. Fly ball out towards right center. Back goes Crisp at the wall. He leaps and can't get it. Falls into the bullpen. It is a three-run home run for Alex Rodriguez. The bid on the catch by Crisp takes him into the pen, but A-Rod has gone deep for the second time tonight. And it is now a 5-2 New York lead.
Well, we talked about plate coverage on the first fly ball out back in the second inning when he hit a fly ball to center field on a ball away. Here's a fastball away again from Schilling, and A-Rod just stays right on it. Front shoulder right on the baseball. The good solid contact, and he finds that bullpen for the Red Sox. What an effort by Crisp as he goes back. He'll leap and fall completely over. Fortunately, did not get hurt on that play.
Now it is Giambi into right and dunks one in front of J.D. Drew. And that is four straight hits now for the Yankees. So off Curt Schilling, all coming with two outs.
Yeah, couple of outs and then the base hit, home run and base hit. And here's A-Rod again. We talked about the balance at home plate. When you're driving the ball out of that part of the ballpark, your balance is excellent. You're staying back and you're driving the ball hard to the opposite field. And they get that pitch away where they wanted it.
That's the third time that he's gone to the opposite field with a home run this year, and he has now got himself a major league record. Fastest to 12 home runs as he does it in the first 15 games. And has homered in three of his last four at-bats. Will Nieves batting for the first time. Came on defensively for Jorge Posada last inning. We've still not yet gotten a report on why Posada left the game. On the ground at Lugo.
will go the easy way to second to conclude the inning. But a three-run home run for Alex Rodriguez has the Yankees on top now, 5-2.
Some people buy the Toyota Tacoma because it's rugged. Some because it retains its value. A Tacoma could also save you thousands compared to similarly priced trucks, which many find appealing. But the vast majority of Tacoma owners are Tacoma owners because of a little thing called Toyota reliability. Should you buy a Tacoma? Ask someone you know who drives one. They're out there.
That's Rusty Wallace, amazing driver. He's also my third cousin once removed. That's his brother, Mike Wallace, driver of the Geico Chevrolet. I could see why Geico sponsors Mike. And when he does well, people will think about saving money on car insurance. Whereas if I were driving that car, all they could think about is, there goes Lauren Wallace, greatest thing that ever climbed into a race car. Poor fella. He has no idea.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
What if everyone checked their washrooms every half hour? Irving does. We inspect and clean our washrooms every 30 minutes. Being obsessed with making things better for you? That's my what if.
Have you heard about the benefits of a reverse mortgage? If you're a homeowner, 62 years or older, and would like to supplement your monthly income, a reverse mortgage could be the key to living comfortably in retirement. U.S. government-insured reverse mortgages allow seniors to convert the equity in their home into cash without having to move or make monthly loan payments. We offer a free information kit and video explaining everything you need to know about a reverse mortgage.
Call 800-300-4519.
Tonight, following Red Sox coverage, stay with Nesson for Sports Desk with Hazel May, presented by F.W. Webb, home of Frank Webb's Bath Centers. Among the topics tonight, Celtics guard Sebastian Telfair was arrested today. Tina Sebastio sits down with David Ortiz to talk about his new book and his Red Sox career in Buckeye Center. Greg Oden, the likely number one pick, is one and done at Ohio State. That's Sports Desk with Hazel May. Tonight, following Red Sox coverage, only on Nesson.
Alex Rodriguez, who had given the Yankees a 2-0 lead earlier, now gives them a 5-2 advantage here into the bottom of the fifth. Well, he is on an amazing tear to begin the year. Dustin Pedroia leading it off as Andy Pettitte has his newfound three-run lead. Pedroia, Lugo, and Yucaris here in the bottom of the fifth. Royal fouling out his first time up. Pettitte giving up the two-run home run to Jason Veritek, the only blemish in his outing so far through the first four innings. Got off to a very good start. The Red Sox offensively to begin the year has loaded up, hitless in his last 12 at bats. As he lifts it to right, Bobby Abreu back a few steps for out number one. The Red Sox Player of the Week is brought to you by your Kia dealers, and this week it's Big Poppy David Ortiz. In six games, hit a 391, three home runs, nine RBIs, and five runs. Red Sox Player of the Week brought to you by Kia dealers, and it's David Ortiz.
They keep that a big secret from us, too, Don. We don't know until we read it on the air. It's hermetically sealed, and finally that envelope is opened, and we find out who the player is.
Actually, I asked for the Kia Player of the Game before the game, and Russ Kent wouldn't give it to me right until now. So they want it kept secret right to the last possible second. Down for Julio Lugo.
Well, you asked the wrong question. You asked for the player of the game instead of the player of the week. He can't give you the player of the game because the game hasn't started yet.
There's the confusion. Swing and a miss. Well, it's 1-2 to Julio Lugo. We put Bob Cousy right on the test there on who should be the draft pick by the Celtics should they have that opportunity.
I kind of figured that he'd say the big man.
It's up top in the count 2-2.
A lot of similarities with the guy he played with for a long time. Of course, you don't put him in that category, but you know, shot blocker. He's still growing. He's only what, 18 years old, right?
That's what they say. Ground right side. Mankiewicz the backhand. A long lead toss, but he gets it there for Pettitte. Nice play. And there's two down in the inning.
Now, as we know, Mankiewicz, a very, very good defensive first baseman. Can go to his right, can go to his left. Nice job there, leading Pettitte to the first base bag. And Pettitte was in a foot race with Lugo, but he'll win that battle. Instead of just throwing the ball, see how Mankiewicz gets the ball and kind of runs toward the play. That gives him a get the ability to make a much better flip to the pitcher than if he was standing still. And he led Pettitte perfectly to the bag.
I mentioned it earlier, Travis Lee, the only first baseman with a better fielding percentage all time. Mattingly pretty good in his own right as he talks it over down there in the Yankees dugout.
I always felt Don Mattingly was the best at the 3-6-3 double play, better than anybody I've ever seen.
Towards center field, Damon on the move, still coming, dives and makes the catch out in left center field. We've seen him do it so many times, this time in the wrong uniform. Red Sox down in order, trailing 5-2.
Flying to Philadelphia for business? If these 11 reasons don't convince you to fly Southwest Airlines nonstop to Philadelphia, maybe this will. Unlike other airlines, our low fares don't have hidden fees.
You are now free to move about the country.
Sometimes the best choice is not having to choose, like our grilled steak and chicken combo. Bertucci's, what's not to love?
Dice game, Matsuzaka era has officially begun.
One nation, one network.
Came to spend some time together, reconnect.
Like when I met her, dice are hot.
Like the names they got.
Non-stop fun.
All in one.
What a thrill.
Hey, I just won.
We're closer.
And we can recall.
Yeah, let's live for the wonder.
Stay tuned after the game for W.B. Mason Extra Innings with Granite City Electric Extra Innings Extra with Tom Karen and Dennis Eckersley. They'll bring you all the post-game reaction from Game 1 of this 2007 season series. You'll hear the comments from both clubhouses and the live press conferences of Terry Francona and Curt Schilling. It's all right after the game in high def on Nesson.
Robinson Cano after the first pitch from Curt Schilling. And Coco Crisp puts it away for out number one.
No, Don, we mentioned many times, as many others have, how much Robinson Cano reminds you of Rod Carew, one of the greatest hitters of all time. And when you look at their stance, a little bit different. Carew here with a little bit more of an open stance, open hips. The bat a little more flat for Carew, but watch when they make contact. Very, very quick hands, very similar swings. That's an excellent shot. The old shot of Rod Carew and Robinson Cano. They're both using open stance. Carew's hips were open a little bit more, but at contact, they both have very quick wrists and hands. And that's where the similarity comes in my opinion. And I kind of noticed that the first couple of times I saw him hit. It just reminded me of Carew.
Looking back, grounder down to first. Euculus will use Schilling, and there's two down. Let's check back in with Tina Servasio.
Don, I'm with a very special person in the stands here right now, Bob Woodruff from ABC News, who was injured in Iraq and is now back and on the air with ABC. First of all, Bob, how are you?
Every day getting better. Just being out here is wonderful.
What brings you here to Fenway Park?
This is my son here, Mac, over here, is a huge Red Sox fan. I grew up in Detroit. I'm a Tigers fan, so I got to stick with that. But he loves the Red Sox, and anytime I can get a chance to come here, I love it.
Now, you and your wife wrote a book about your experience in an instant, and how are people receiving that out there?
It's been overwhelming. The first 4 weeks when it came out, we were first in the country. Now it's down to about six, but still cranking.
And what is your next story, Bob? I know you're out there working again already.
Now it's getting right back to journalism again. So I'm getting on the road and covering things both here in this country and overseas, hopefully very soon.
It's great to see you here, Bob. Thank you for joining
us. Thanks for inviting me.
Back to you, Don.
Okay, Tina, thank you very much.
Now, very lucky to be alive. What an incredible comeback he has made from devastating injuries over there in Iraq.
Cambridge grounding a foul outside of first base. I didn't realize he had a book out about it. I look forward to reading that in the near future. Yes, enjoys the ball game tonight. Two down here in the sixth. McCabe staying alive as Schilling in the low 90s right now. 91 at the moment for Schilling with two outs in the inning. There is action in the Red Sox pen for the first time tonight. Kyle Snyder is up. Hopper hit hard at Pedroia. A 7-pitch, 1-2-3 inning for Schilling. We head to the bottom of the sixth, 5-2 Yankees.
Yikes, you got the middle, but that's okay. You got Wendy's new Steakhouse Double Melt. You know how good the middle can be. Caramelized onions and mushrooms, bacon, creamy Swiss and peppercorn sauce melted in the middle of two hot and juicy, fresh, never frozen beef patties. Good move, Mr. 14B. You just landed in the best position to do what tastes right.
Olympia Sports is your majestic headquarters, featuring the new thermo-based technology that insulates while maintaining temperature control. Get it at Olympia Sports. Shop with confidence, satisfaction guaranteed.
My neighbor drove all over town to find the best deal on a cell phone. I just logged on to Let's Talk. They make it easy to compare plans from all major carriers and find cell phone deals that are much cheaper than retail.
Like the hot BlackBerry Pearl with music and video player, a $369 value, yours free after mail-in rebate and new calling plan.
Let's Talk has the best prices, the best plans, and the most free phones guaranteed.
Log on to 25letstalk.com or call now to order your BlackBerry Pearl. Let's Talk, the smarter way to shop for cell phones. So log on or call now.
So easy to turn, so easy to handle. It almost drives itself. But it's not just about mowing the lawn. It's also about owning a John Deere. Easy Track, the newest John Deere.
Have you driven a Ford?
Think you know everything about the Ford Fusion? Think again. It's time to see for yourself while the all-wheel drive Fusion beat out Camry and Accord on performance, handling, and styling. Need more? How about that Fusion was named J.D. Power's most appealing car in its class? Lease one for just $199 a month, and your first payment's on us. Only at your local Ford store.
Have you Monday at 6 o'clock, Olympia Sports presents the Boston Globe pregame show with Tom Caron and Dennis Eckersley. They'll discuss the Blue Jays being here and the Sox facing Tomooka once again. They'll also talk about Tim Wakefield and his hot start. And Gordon Eads and Nick Cafato have the latest from the Sox clubhouse in Major League Baseball. Coverage begins with Monster Monday at 5:30 live in high definition on NESN.
Last half of the sixth inning, 5-2. The Yankees on top. Andy Pettitte back on the mound. We're here at Fenway Park in Boston. Don Orsillo, Jerry Remy, and Tina Sabathia bringing you Boston Red Sox baseball in high definition. Dolby Digital 5.1 surround sound on NESN. A 5-2 Yankees lead as Ortiz hits a two-hopper at Mankiewicz for the first out of the inning.
Well, the changeup tonight has been a very good pitch for Randy Pettitte, and I don't remember him throwing all that many last time around at the Yankees, but quite a few in this ballgame tonight. He's got a couple of big outs with the changeup. Changeup here to David Ortiz, lefty against lefty, but he still throws him the changeup, and Ortiz with the ground ball out to Mankiewicz.
Well, it's his fourth start of the season tonight. And the 22nd of his career against the Red Sox. Broken bat grounder. Hit off the side of the mound. Changed direction, but Cano throws out Ramirez. Two down. Pettitte was trying to get away from the bat, which ended up on the third base side off the mound. As he was kind of ducking out of the way, not sure where the bat went. But it hit off the mound, did the ball, and right to Robinson Cano.
Well, and Andy Pettitte is one of those pitchers throughout his career that has broken a lot of bats. And a lot of them because of the cut fastball, usually in. That one's away, breaks the bat of Manny, and just easy out at first base. You don't see Manny break many bats.
Well, Drew promptly lines one into center field. His third hit of the night. Well, I'll give you an idea about J.D. Drew. He's spraying it all over. He's got a couple singles to center, one to right.
And Pettitte really upset with himself after this. First pitch fastball. J.D. Drew jumps all over it. And Pettitte not happy with that. He had a couple of quick outs. Gives up the base hit to Drew. So Drew, who came in the game at 375 against Pettitte, three more hits tonight.
He's having a great night. The rest of the Red Sox not following suit. As he is 3-for-3. Everybody else 3-for-17. Nick Lowell had a two-out single last time up, and it set up the two-run home run by Jason Veritek that at the time tied the game two aside. Pettitte re-signing with the Yankees as a free agent this past offseason after 3 years in Houston. His best season 2005 with the Astros when he was 17-9 with a 2.39 ERA. Jeter will go the easy way to second to end the inning. We played six from Fenway Park at 5-2 Yankees.
Magical adventure of the year begins like this.
Geronimo!
Who invited you on board?
This is place.
From the creators of Shrek and Madagascar.
They call me Shocky.
Get ready.
Everybody dance now!
Oh.
To get down. Flushed away.
Tune to Channel 1 to watch this movie now. Time Warner Cable.
Hammond Street, Bangor, is the home of the Sports Arena and BangorTickets.com.
They really
really use you good.
Ellsworth elevates to a 100,000-mile warranty at the top of the hill on Route 3.
Where the value is real.
Plus, best-in-class fuel efficiency and pure GMC trucks are less than Chevy.
I found Darling's with the best price.
Family vans with best-in-class fuel efficiency, 4x4 Jeeps with electronic stability.
They're willing to go the extra mile.
It's like having family in the business.
And we welcome all credit scores at Darling's Ellsworth Auto Mall.
Tom and Lori paid over $9,000 to sell their home. Tom and Becky called Assist to Sell and paid just $29.95. Their real estate experts will show and sell your home and arrange inspections and paperwork for as low as $29.95. Imagine what you can do with all that extra cash. Assist to Sell, the only way to sell your home.
Assist to Sell has changed Maine real estate forever, saving buyers and sellers over $1 million in commissions in just 2 years.
They'll sell your home for as low as $29.95, serving Eastern, Central, Northern, and Down East Maine.
Assist to Sell, the only way to sell your home.
Game break, the Indians taking on the Devil Rays. Travis Hafner is hot. That's his third homer of the year, a two-run shot, a second and four game, a 3-2 lead. CC Sabathia trying to go to 4-0 for the Tribe. It's back to Fenway.
Top half of the seventh inning, thanks Tom. 5-2, the Yankees on top. And Schilling back on the mound. He's thrown 93 pitches tonight as he begins things here in the seventh inning. The top of the Yankees order, Johnny Damon and Derek Jeter. And Bobby Abreu expected in the inning. Damon tonight 0 for 3. He's grounded out to second, grounded out to short, and struck out looking. And swing and a miss, and he's down 0-2. He's had the best of them so far tonight. Reaches out, slaps it foul off to the left. Action in the Red Sox pen. It was Snyder last inning. This inning it's J.C. Romero. Curry is a premier leadoff guy that you were in your major league career. Where do you rank Johnny Damon as far as leadoff guys go?
Well, the all-time leadoff guy was Ricky Henderson. And I was not a premier leadoff guy because I didn't walk very much.
I was being kind.
Yeah, I know you were. But Damon has been an excellent leadoff man. You know, scores a lot of runs. I mean, we saw it here with the Red Sox. We saw it in Kansas City. We saw it in Oakland. And now they're seeing it in New York. But tonight, Schilling has had the upper hand against Johnny Damon.
And some fans getting on Damon as he heads down. Dunkin' Donuts is in its eighth year of hosting local youth groups and charitable organizations in the Dunkin' dugout. Special seating section at Fenway. Thousands of children have had the opportunity to catch a Red Sox home game thanks to Dunkin' Donuts. And they're enjoying a good one tonight here at Fenway Park. Not if the Red Sox fans at the moment down 5-2. But at least seeing the Yankees here in Red Sox. Deep in the hole. Lugo, the long throw. Picked by Youkilis. They got him. Nice play. Lugo and Youkilis combined on the out of Derek Jeter.
Well, Julio Lugo has played a very excellent shortstop for the Red Sox. Had to cover a lot of ground. The tough pop there is getting stopped and planted to make the throw to first base. 1 foot on the grass. And then at the other end, Kevin Youkilis with the scoop.
Six in a row now, retired by Schilling. Little help from his friends as Abreu stands in. Schilling has just reached the 100 pitch mark. That's 86 pitches through five. And has made a pretty quick work of the Yankees over the last inning in 2/3. Didn't look like there for a while he was going to make it into the sixth inning, but here and now with two outs in the seventh. Swing. Boston Red Sox baseball on Nesson is brought to you by Rico, Coors Light, and LP Lumber. 1-2 the count to Bobby Abreu. Two outs here in the seventh inning. Fooled him and struck him out. Two K's in the inning, five and all for Schilling. Seventh inning stretch, 5-2 Yankees. And time for Sports Desk Update with Hazel May.
John, thank you. Hi again, everybody. Coming up tonight on Sports Desk, presented by FW Web, home of Frank Webb's Bass Centers, we have a one-on-one conversation with new author David Ortiz. In his just-released autobiography, Big Poppy explains why he doesn't hate the Yankees. That's tonight, immediately following Red Sox postgame coverage. Don and Jerry back after this quick timeout.
At VIP Parts, Tires, and Service, we know how to show you and your car a little love. Need tires? Our Speed Lane pros help you make the right selection for the best price guaranteed, and we'll install them in under an hour. No wasted time. Just the biggest selection of name brand quality tires, Michelin, Pirelli, Goodyear, and more in stock when you need them. Installed by qualified service techs faster than anywhere. When you need quality name brand tires, make an appointment in our Speed Lane bay. VIP. A little love goes a long way.
The import with a taste as big as Canada. Molson Canadian. Here's to good nature.
Hey, Les.
What's up? It's Tom.
Hi, Vince.
It's Tom.
Hi, Dave.
Felipe.
Hi, Xavier.
Hello, Terry.
Hey, Floyd.
What up, Steve-O?
What up, Ken?
How's it going, Jebediah?
It's Tom.
Double brewed iced coffee in your favorite flavors, served just the way you like it. Come on, who knows you better than Dunkin' Donuts? America runs on Dunkin'.
Stop by Dunkin' Donuts today and add one of our nine delicious flavors to your coffee free.
Time now for the Panasonic Plasma Replay. So you can catch this again in crisp, rich, detailed motion. And it's the Jason Veritek home run, a two-run home run, the only two runs the Red Sox have so far in this ballgame.
Jason Veritek with a two-run home run in the fourth inning. Leads it off in the bottom of the seventh. Red Sox trailing down by three runs. Curt Schilling, 103 pitches through seven, gathering his stuff and heading to the clubhouse. So far, nobody warming in the Red Sox pen. So J.C. Romero up in the pen last inning. Check sends it out towards left center field. Damon on the move, but it'll fall in front of him for a hit. Lead runner on for Boston in the seventh.
I believe that's only the second time tonight they have had the leadoff man on in this ball game. J.D. Drew in the second. Now Veritek with the base hit here in the seventh inning. So Veritek, a couple of hits in the game, including the home run.
Here's Coco Crisp, who is 0 for 2. Struck out in the third. Grounded out to short in the fourth inning. Well, some feel that one of the overriding factors and one of the reasons that Roger Clemens may go to the Yankees this season is because of his great friend Andy Pettitte. And of course, one of the reasons Roger wanted to pitch in Houston was because it was in Houston, but also because Andy Pettitte was there. Now his great friend has returned to New York, and some wonder if that'll be enough to lure Roger along with enough money to go to New York once again.
You got to follow the money trail first of all, and then of course whether Roger wants to leave Houston and the comfortable conditions that he operates in down there. I guess he's supposed to make some kind of announcement soon, isn't he? Whether he's going to return or not, they say sometime in May.
And the time frame not all that different from what he did last year. As Chris fouls it off to our right, back and out of play. A full line of media up here with us, of course, at tonight's game. As you might imagine, a Red Sox-Yankees tilt televised by ESPN. Nesson, yes, and into Japan, both on Fuji TV and NHK. For a full gathering of television booths being filled up here, along with the radio across the world. And there's a look at, on an average night, you got a couple of cameras in center, but working six shows. The media actually is down from where they expected it as far as the press box goes, because Matsui's not here. And what had been on Sunday another Daisuke up against Matsui type situation like we saw with Ichiro, where the large contingent of Japanese media were here. It would have been a similar type situation had Matsui been active.
Well, by the look of that last shot there, it didn't look like many have missed this game.
John Blake was saying that there were considerably less than they had anticipated, but you're right, it was still an enormous gathering. And this one, line foul. Look out. I got in there hard and fast. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up to Coco Crisp. Chopped down the third baseline. Rodriguez to the back end. The long throw. Will Pullman-Kavich off the bag.
Rodriguez going to the backhand and to the line, and the throw's going to sail on him just a little bit. Mankiewicz has to go up. The foot comes off, and Crisp hits the bag. Good call. Louis Alessia, the first base coach, first making the call. That'll probably go as a base hit, I would think. We'll have to wait and see what the call is. We're gonna have a pinch hit of Willie Mopena coming out for Pedroia, because one swing of the bat from Pena and it could be a tie score.
It is a base hit for Coco Crisp in the long at bat. And Willie Mo's gonna get a shot here. There is action in the Yankees pen. And Scott Proctor, the right-hander, is up. Willie Mopena against Pettitte is 3-for-7 with 429. Pedroia had been 0-for-2 in the ballgame tonight. Willie Mopena with one home run. With a solo shot to lead off the third inning off Toronto's Gustavo Chacin on Tuesday. And it takes strike one from Pettitte.
Seems like when Pettitte's been in a little bit of trouble, he's going to that changeup, a changeup on the first pitch to Pena.
The first two have reached here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Veritek at second, Crisp at first. Swing and a miss from Willie Moe.
Yep, change up again. I mean, not a good one. It was up in the zone, but still off speed, and no contact by Pena. So back-to-back changeups.
This has been an area when Pena has gotten down, and most pitchers then go to the breaking stuff. Yeah. Cause problems for Willie Moe. Doesn't chase, and it's 1-2. And And he's so far 2-for-3 against left-handed pitchers, and that was Gustavo Chacin, 0-for-7 against right-handers in his young season. Just off the outside edge, framed by Nieves.
Yeah, tried to go to that cut fastball to the outside corner and just missed.
Pettitte about to throw his 100th pitch of the night. Pettitte wants to talk to Will Nieves.
One thing to keep in mind, if the Red Sox can come back in this ball game and get a lead late in the game, highly unlikely you would see Jonathan Papelbon in this game tonight. He's worked in back-to-back games up in that Toronto series, and I believe, what, 26 pitches last night for
yes.
him?
Yeah, 28 the night before, and that was really less than a 24-hour period jammed in there with the night game followed by the early start in the day game yesterday. And as we mentioned at the time yesterday, most likely unavailable tonight for his first of three against the Yankees. The 2-2 to Willie Moe. Pena strikes out. Big strikeout for Pettitte in the first out here of the seventh. Three K's on the night now for Pettitte.
Take a look at the pitching sequence from Pettitte to Pena. As he starts him off with a couple of changeups. This one for a strike and a changeup that's up in the zone that Pena can't hit. Tries to cut fastball for a ball. Tries to cut fastball again away. Just missing. And then that looked to be a changeup again from Pettitte. And that's going to be the night for Randy Pettitte.
So Andy Pettitte goes 6 1/3 innings and departs, having thrown 100 pitches. This call to the bullpen is brought to you by your local Ford store. Your journey begins with a bold move. Start your journey today by visiting your local Ford store. It's a 5-2 Yankees lead with one out in the seventh.
Just roll, roll, everybody roll, 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 everybody roll!
Shoe with a removable wheel in the heel that lets you walk or run, and then by simply shifting your weight to your heels, you're rolling. Heelys, hang out or drop in. It's all about the wheel in the heel. Get it at Olympia Sports.
Heelys.
Hello?
Mrs. Anderson, this is Mark Brown. I'm from the collections department of...
Hi. Listen, I'm sorry I haven't made my payment yet. I'll get it in as soon as I can.
Maybe you should call In Charge. They'll work with you and come up with a solution that's right for you.
When life hands you a little more than you can manage, call In Charge Debt Solutions. We're a nonprofit company that puts people back in control by helping them manage their debt. We'll stop the collection calls and we'll help lower your interest rates so you'll have one affordable monthly payment. Call In Charge today.
Try KFC Famous Bowls. Freshly prepared with our home-style mashed potatoes, layered with sweet corn, all white meat crispy chicken, and topped with our signature gravy and three cheese blend. Dig into great layers of flavor with KFC Famous Bowls.
Stay in the game with an hour of post-game coverage on NESN. It's your post-game all-access pass with WB Mason's Extra Innings and Granite City Electric's Extra Innings Extra.
Back at Fenway, where this game summary is brought to you by your local Lincoln Mercury dealers. Home runs tonight for Alex Rodriguez, who came into the game with 10. He's got two more. His first one at the time for the Yankees on top, 2-0. He would get Schilling again. A three-run shot over Coco Crisp, who goes into the bullpen on the bid. But it puts the Yankees on top 5-2. The only blemish for Andy Pettitte, a two-run shot by Jason Baratek, who connects in his first home run of the season. But it is a 5-2 Yankees lead. Pettitte leads after 6 1/3 and hands the baseball off to Scott Proctor, who deals with Julio Lugo with one out. Jason Baratek at second and Coco Crisp at first.
Scott Proctor last year led the American League with 83 appearances for the New York Yankees, already making his 10th of this season. 9 1/3 innings, 6 hits, allowed 3 earned runs. He's walked 5 and struck out 6.
On a strike to Lugo, who has grounded to short, walked and grounded out to first base. There's double barreled action now in the Yankees pen. Vizcaino, the right-hander, and Mike Myers, who likely will have another duel with David Ortiz at some point. Chuck swing foul.
That's the same Mike Myers that volunteered to become a starting pitcher for the Yankees with all their injuries.
And volunteered a few years ago when the Red Sox were in need of a closer. He was volunteered for just about everything. Joe Torre, I don't think, gave it all that much thought from what I read.
It'd be tough to stretch him out, you know?
Yeah. Considering that his normal outing is a batter or two. To right field, Bobby Abreu has it lined up, makes the catch, and no advance for the base runners. Veritek remains at second, two down. Yevis back out on the mound to talk to Proctor. Runners at first and second. The responsibility of the departed starter, Andy Pettitte. Went to 6 1/3 tonight, 8 hits. And so far, 2 runs, the 2-run home run by Veritek. Walked 2 and struck out 3. Chance to win his second game, this being his 5th appearance of the year. Nicholas has been hit by a pitch tonight. He was hit on the hand by Andy Pettitte in the first inning. Reached on a hit in the third and then fly to center in the 5th. Up a mile high left side of the infield. A-Rod underneath it. Makes the catch and ends the inning. Red Sox got the first two on. They didn't advance. They strand them. 5-2 Yankees.
With convenient flights every day, Southwest Airlines gives you the freedom to do business out of town and still come home at night.
Winston, I'm home!
With 23 daily nonstops from Manchester and Providence to Baltimore, Washington, Southwest is taking low fares farther.
You are now free to move about the country.
Know what would be great? Having a DVD player wherever you go. At the Chrysler National Minivan Sale, get a factory-installed rear-seat DVD player at no extra charge. Plus, very well-qualified buyers get 0% financing on J.D. Power & Associates' highest-ranked van in initial quality, Chrysler Town & Country, with 2 rows of stow-and-go seats. Your kids will thank you, and you'll thank us. Discover America's hottest products at your Chrysler dealer.
Take these to Rogers and Lewis.
Newman's Own Organics Iced Coffee from McDonald's. Now even harder to resist in vanilla, hazelnut, or our new limited time flavor, caramel.
Grubs, their mission, destroy your lawn.
Now there's Bayer Advanced season-long grub control with Merit. Its exclusive 2-in-1 formula stops grubs all season. Plus, it revitalizes your lawn, guaranteed. Bayer Advanced.
A splitter looks like a fastball until velocity is lost and the bottom drops out. Watch every pitch in clear Panasonic motion. Panasonic Plasma for the speed of sports. Panasonic.
5-2, Yankees on top. It's time now for Tina Servacio on the Jordans' third base deck. Tina?
Thank you, Don. I'm at Jordan's Pavilion with the fans on the third base deck. Now, this offseason, it was well documented that the Yankees wanted to negotiate with Daisuke Matsuzaka just as bad as the Red Sox. Well, this winter, I spoke with general manager Brian Cashman about how he felt when he lost the negotiating bid to the Red Sox.
I was bummed out. I mean, they got a great pitcher. Daisuke Matsuzaka is the real deal, at least by all evaluations. I don't think you're going to find any baseball individual with any expertise throughout the world who's going to tell you otherwise. Daisuke Matsuzaka is a rare talent, a rare find, and hence the aggressive bidding process by not just the Red Sox who won it, but everybody that was a participant in it. And so congratulations to them.
And Matsuzaka will get his first taste of the Red Sox-Yankees rivalry when he starts on Sunday night here at Fenway. Don?
Okay, Tina, yeah, I'll be matched up against Chase Wright, the rookie for the Yankees, 1-0 so far this season. But it was amazing. You know, the Yankees did end up getting Kei Egawa at a much smaller price. But I think at first thought, most thought, the Yankees may be the highest bidder. But certainly Red Sox Nation happy that it was indeed the Red Sox who were and won the rights, $51 million. It cost them to get the rights, but it's been fun to watch so far.
Yeah, most of the other teams were all right in that same neighborhood, what, in the mid-30s? And then the Red Sox just blew everybody away with that $51 million.
Red Sox with J.C. Romero now into the game after 7 innings from Schilling. Cora takes over at second base. Pedroia had been hit for by Willie Mopeña. And here's Alex Rodriguez. He's homered twice tonight. He faces J.C. Romero.
Eighth appearance for J.C. Romero. He made that seventh appearance last night in Toronto, pitching an inning, giving up a hit, had a walk and a strikeout.
And the pitcher strike and the count is 2-2. Well, you can debate all day whether Scott Boras is good or bad for the game from a fan perspective. The players will tell you, obviously, that he has done amazing things for them. But certainly, I think for those who watched the Matsuzaka posting and everything that took place after that, had to really appreciate the work that he does from an agent standpoint. I mean, virtually, there was not much leverage. As Allen missing the ball, not by much.
You got A-Rod jumping away here, but it looks like a strike. J.C. Romero thought he had a strike as he turns his back to home plate.
The Boras appeared to create leverage that was really not there. I mean, it would have been very difficult, I think, for Daisuke to go back to Japan. And by all accounts, they didn't really want him back. As this one is lined into left field to the corner. And Ramirez over to dig it out. Heading for two is Rodriguez. And the night continues for A-Rod.
Well, the average now for Alex Rodriguez up to 377. This is a changeup from J.C. Romero that stays up. And again, that great balance. I mean, he's just seeing the ball so well right now. And everything off his bat is a line drive. Even the out that he hit to center field tonight was hit pretty well back in the second inning.
Action in the Red Sox pen behind Romero. It's Pinheiro, the right-hander. And shift on for Giambi, who stands in. Into right field, falling fast. That's in for a hit. Drew over to cover it. A-Rod coming around. The throw is going to be not in time, and the Yankees take a 6-2 lead.
That was a very good read by Alex Rodriguez at second base. One of the things they tell you at second base, check how deep the outfield is playing. Of course, they all play deep when Giambi's at the plate, but he read that ball was going to drop in right at contact. He was off. is contact, and right away Alex Rodriguez knows that ball's going to drop in front of J.D. Drew, and he scores without a problem.
Another pinch runner for Giambi at first base. It's a Kevin Thompson. And it is indeed runs for Giambi at first. Will Nieves with Thompson now at first. Nieves grounding it to third. Lowell quickly to second base. That's just all they'll get, the lead runner for the first out of the inning. Well, off the top, we have the graphic talking about Alex Rodriguez, Jerry, and he's only added to it now, first in a lot more categories.
Adding the two home runs tonight to get 12 on the season, a 377 average now, first in the lead, just a little bit ahead of Placido Polanco of the Tigers. I know it's a little bit early to be talking about, but that's the kind of start that he's off to. And we're getting a chance tonight to see it firsthand. We've been seeing it on highlights and reading about it, but we're seeing it firsthand tonight at Fenway Park.
Here's Robinson Cano. Cano with a single in the third inning. Grounded out to first and then fly to center. Schilling touch for five runs in his seven innings of work tonight. And the ground foul beyond the Red Sox dugout, and that is a packed photographer as well. Not much room to move on a ground ball over in that direction.
So many teams doing the game tonight. Cameras down there, television cameras, and all kind of stuff hanging around this ballpark. And it'll be like that all weekend long.
Of course, unfortunately for us, unable to do a game after tonight.
No, we're done. One and done.
Fox tomorrow and ESPN on Sunday night. Oh, takes it the opposite way to deep left, back towards the wall and high off the wall. And he plays the Karen quickly back in, holding Cano to a long single. As to third base, on the wall ball single goes Nieves.
Now those hits starting to pile up now for the Yankees as Cano goes to the opposite field, high off that left field wall. And if he'd have been running out of the box, he may have had a double. He was looking at it. Man, he plays it with the bare hand and gets it back into second base. So that kind of keeps a double play in order for the Red Sox. Up comes Terry Francona. And with Melky Cabrera coming to play, looks like he's going to go for Joel Pinheiro. Actually, my mistake. Kyle Snyder will be coming in.
Snyder on the way in with the Yankees now on top 6-2.
We're up to a million hits.
Sweet.
Who is it?
Chuck Norris.
Yeah, right. Chuck.
Bob's Discount Furniture gives birth to a new age in leather, purchasing direct from factories all over the world. Buying a leather living room will never be the same.
Sofa and love seat, or sofa, chair, and ottoman, your choice, only $17.99.
I can't be beat, I won't be beat. No way, no how.
If you owe over $10,000 to the IRS or state, call American Tax Relief for a free consultation. We've helped thousands of Americans settle their tax debt for a fraction of what they owed.
Once we hired American Tax Relief, the IRS stopped contacting us. That was an immediate relief.
And they settled our tax debt for a fraction of what we owed.
If you owe over $10,000 to the IRS or state, we can help you settle for less, maybe a lot less.
Call 800-294-1563 for your free consultation.
Stay tuned after the game for WB Mason Extra Innings with Tom Karen and Dennis Eckersley. You'll see the live press conferences with Terry Francona and Curt Schilling. Plus, that breaks down the performances of the two starters tonight and the comprehensive coverage from our team of reporters. It's all right after the game in high definition on Nesson.
6-2. The Yankees now on top as they have added a run so far here in the top of the eighth inning. One down. New pitcher is Kyle Snyder.
Fifth appearance for Snyder. The last time he worked was in that series against the Angels. It's been a long time. That was back on the 16th when he worked an inning against LA. Opponents hitting 167 off Snyder. 3 1/3 innings total for him.
Rivas at third. Cano across the diamond at first with one out. Lucky Cabrera to battle.
Cano one steal on the season. He's been caught a couple of times.
A single in the third for Cabrera sends in his fly to center. Grounded out to first.
Good change up from Kyle Snyder. Cabrera obviously looking fastball first pitch, fooled by that change up.
Had a foul down the third baseline, and it's 0-2.
You see what throwing an off-speed pitch on that first pitch means. I mean, he had Cabrera off balance on that changeup, then fouls with the fastball and a very late swing by Melky Cabrera.
Cabrera really getting a chance to play a lot last year in the absence of Matt Suey, and of course the Sheffield going down also. And very valuable, ended up in 130 games after starting the season with the Columbus Clippers to begin the year last year. 31 games at AAA and 130 with the Yankees. Ended up hitting 280, 7 homers and 50 runs batted in. Was up top to get him, foul tipped into Veritek's mitt.
And we kind of had Melky Cabrera confused right from the first pitch of that at bat when he threw him a changeup. Here he goes up and out of the zone with the fastball and throws it by Melky Cabrera. Melky Cabrera, remember when he first came up, he made an error. But then last year played very, very good defense for the Reds, for the Yankees.
There were 12 outfield assists last year for Melky Cabrera.
And we'll show you in a little while a catch he made against Manny Ramirez.
Two down, runners at first and third for Dugman Cabich. Through the last season with Kyle Farnsworth on the mound, and Manny sending one deep until robbed by Melky Cabrera. The five defensive plays he made a year ago. Left to third and the first does not throw to either location. Snyder, third Boston pitcher of the night. Romero began the inning, so far charged with a run. Responsible for the runners at first and third.
Now the attention played to Cano here. A lot of times with two outs, and the teams will attempt the double steal. Five stolen bases for Cano last season. Pitch in the dirt. And to pull off that play, you don't need the speed at first base. You do need some at third. Now, it's Nieves at third base, not great speed there. And a lot of times when they do try that play, it's when a hit is down a couple of strikes in the count. Another changeup on a 2-0 count. Put away. Baratek coming out of the crouch to reel it in. 3-0. On top of the Yankees order, Johnny Damon waiting on deck with two outs here in the eighth. The Yankees have collected yet another run. They now lead it 6-2. Ball four to Watchman Kavich. This will load him up for Johnny Damon. Well, Damon had a very tough night against Curt Schilling. Curt struck him out twice. He did get an RBI and a ground out back in the third. Only Evans at third base. Cano at second. And Kavich at first with two outs here in the eighth. Mentioned the tough night for Damon, 0 for 4, a couple of strikeouts against Curt Schilling. Damon always very good with the bases loaded, and in fact, number one among active players with the bases loaded, up over 400. In front, Kevin Millar, second at 396. Swings through that, the count evens at 1-1. Red Sox trailed 2-0 tonight with Jason Baratek tied the game with a two-run home run. The Yankees on a three-run shot by A-Rod pulled ahead 5-2. They've added another, and now Damon grounds to second. Cora's throw to first base ends the inning. And Snyder gets out of any further trouble as the Yankees leave him loaded, but it's now 6-2 New York.
What does it take to earn AMCI's best-in-class certification for acceleration? New full-size Toyota Tundra, the truck that's changing it all.
Every texture, every line, every nuance, created with one thing in mind. At Lexus of Portland.
Take a look at these great Sullivan Tire deals.
Stop in at Sullivan Tire now through April 28th and buy four select Dunlop tires and get your choice of either a $100 Kobe portable DVD player or a $50 mail-in rebate. And as an extra plus, buy four Dunlops at Sullivan Tire and you'll get an added $50 off instantly. So you could save up to $150 in value, but this double deal on Dunlop is only at Sullivan Tire.
For the best tire deals, come to Sullivan Tire. We're always here to get you there.
Stay tuned after the game for Granite City Electric Extra Innings Extra with John Karen and Dennis Eckersley. You'll get the complete post-game reaction, including comments from both clubhouses and live press conferences from Curt Schilling and Terry Francona, plus a preview of games 2 and 3 of the series this weekend. It's all after the game in high definition, and it's only on NESN.
6-2. The Yankees on top now as we head to the bottom of the eighth. Mike Myers into the game for New York.
Now he's been very good so far this season. This will be his 10th appearance. He's pitched 7 2/3, 2 hits allowed, not a run. He has walked 4, struck out 4. Opponents hitting 0-83. David Ortiz, you saw the 2-for-11, but a dramatic home run a year ago here at Fenway Park against Mike Myers.
Drives it out towards the gap in left center field. It'll one hop the wall. Damon plays the carom. Ortiz headed for 2, and the throw not in time. Wow, he went in very awkwardly.
He's lucky he didn't turn an ankle or hurt a knee with that slide.
Half slide, half fall, but he was really undecided as to what he was going to do.
Looks like he couldn't make his mind up. Do I slide or do I stand up? He's very fortunate he didn't get hurt on that. That's how you blow out knees and blow out ankles.
Myers on to face just the one batter. David Ortiz, Myers gone. After Ortiz doubles back to Fenway after this, 6-2 Yankees.
Dating do's and don'ts.
What I can tell you is
good dating tips.
He carries a gun.
That would be big, especially on the first date.
Negative.
Maybe try to make a little eye contact.
I'm just looking for chicks who aren't boring, basically.
Oh my God. I wouldn't probably go much further than that, you know?
All right.
Do you have Sox Appeal? Visit SoxAppeal.com for complete casting information.
And this is where it hurts, my neck.
Climbing, I absolutely love it.
Where is a good place to put my feet and where can I go from there? And then you just start climbing. I get sore everywhere, but my neck has been getting really painful. I was robot girl where I couldn't move, couldn't turn. I recently tried the Aleve liquid gels. I loved them because they are very quick. They've really helped a lot with the pain in my neck. The Aleve liquid gels helped me get back on the rock. They're in my purse at all times.
You can see the Sox on the road with packages from Red Sox destinations. Trips to New York, Arizona, San Diego, Baltimore, and Chicago are available now. They include tickets, accommodations, a tour, and a reception with a Red Sox player. Call 877-3-GAME-ON or 617-226-6400. Visit redsox.com/redsoxdestinations today.
Well, David Ortiz at second base, a leadoff double. Luis Vizcaino into the game.
And he was part of that trade that sent Randy Johnson back to Arizona, making his 10th appearance. Manny, one hit off him. It's a home run.
Strike one to Ramirez over the outside corner. Vizcaino came into the big leagues in 2000 as a member of the Oakland A's, tying with the A's, Milwaukee Brewers, the White Sox, and Arizona last season. 70 appearances last year for the Diamondbacks.
Back-to-back slide is to start off Ramirez, and quickly it's ahead in the count 0-2. Manny thought the first one was outside. This one certainly a strike.
Mariano Rivera up in the Yankees pen. Rivera does not have a save And right now, not a save situation. A four-run advantage for the Yankees as the pitch missing for a ball to Manny Ramirez, 1-2. Mike Myers started the inning facing just David Ortiz. Red Sox have a lefty and J.D. Drew waiting on deck. And Joe Torre electing to have the right-hander Luis Vizcaino face Manny. As he evens the count now at 2-2.
Mentioned Rivera. Rivera hasn't worked since last Sunday, and in that game, that's when he gave up that walk-off home run to Marco Scudero. But he's been off a few days.
Side full count. This guy was ahead 0-2, but Manny has worked it full.
Said he died of sliders with the exception of one fastball.
Before he walks in, another base runner for the Red Sox, Manny down to first.
Again, he tries that slider on the 3-2 count and misses the outside corner.
And Ron Guidry's going to head out. And talk to Vizcaino as he'll deal with J.D. Drew.
I think Vizcaino's had some problems with walks here early in the season. That's his 7th walk in 9 1/3 inning. Well, stay tuned after the game for WB Mason Extra Innings and Granite City Electric Extra Innings Extra with Sean Caron and Dennis Eckersley. They'll bring you all the post-game reaction from game one of this series. You'll hear the comments from both clubhouses and the live press conferences of Jerry Francona and Curt Schilling. It's all right after the game in high definition on NESN.
First and second, nobody out. J.D. Drew 2-for-7, couple of home runs in his career against Luis Vizcaino. A swing and a miss at the first pitch. He's had a nice night tonight. 3 hits in 3 at bats, 2 singles to center and a single to right. On the ground right side, Cano ranges. That's just one play and just makes it. Close play at first, but Drew is out. On to third goes Ortiz. Ramirez to second. One out in the inning.
I think Cano may have been a little bit surprised there at the speed of J.D. Drew. He has to go far to his left to make this play, but then took a couple of extra steps and almost cost him at first base.
One down, second and third, and it brings up Mike Lowell. Running into a double play, single, and reached on a fielder's choice. 1-for-5 in his career against Vizcaino. A strike to Lowell. Jason Veritek waits on deck. He supplied the 2 runs tonight for the Red Sox with his first home run of the season. And is back in the 4th inning. On the ground and by the dive of A-Rod into left. Ortiz scores. On to third goes Manny. It's an RBI single for Mike Lowell. And it's a 6-3 Yankees lead now.
And that'll speed things up for Joe Torre out in that bullpen with Rivera. Once again, another breaking ball. What a slide is from Vizcaino, and Lowell finds that hole between third and short. Lowell picks up his 10th run batted of the season, and the Red Sox within three.
And Nieves out to the mound again to talk to Vizcaino.
Well, you wonder if this is the stall for a little time to make sure Rivera's ready. I mean, we've seen it plenty of times where Rivera's been in this part of the ball game, and it looks like it's going to happen right now. Remember, he's been off since Sunday.
Well, in this instance, Joe Torre will be looking for five outs for Mariano Rivera as he brings him on with one out. Here in the last of the eighth, and the Red Sox back within three now. It's 6-3 in New York. Here the pitching change from Fenway here in the bottom of the eighth.
Roll, roll, everybody roll. Roll, roll, everybody roll!
The only shoe with a removable wheel in the heel that lets you walk or run, and then by simply shifting your weight to your heels, you're rolling. Heelys, hang out or drop in. It's all about the wheel in the heel. Get it at Olympia Sports.
Heelys. Try KFC Famous Bowls. Freshly prepared with our homestyle mashed potatoes, layered with sweet corn, all white meat crispy chicken, and topped with our signature gravy and three cheese blend. Dig into great layers of flavor with KFC Famous Bowls.
Hello?
Mrs. Anderson, this is Mark Brown. I'm from the collections department.
Hi. Listen, I'm sorry I haven't made my payment yet. I'll get it in as soon as I can.
Maybe you should call In Charge. They'll work with you and come up with a solution that's right for you.
When life hands you a little more than you can manage, call In Charge Debt Solutions. We're a nonprofit company that puts people back in control by helping them manage their debt. We'll stop the collection calls and we'll help lower your interest rates so you'll have one affordable monthly payment. Call In Charge today.
Stay in the game with an hour of post-game coverage on Nesson. It's your post-game all-access pass with WB Mason's Extra Innings and Granite City Electric's Extra Innings Extra.
Back at Fenway, the Yankees on top, 6-3 here in the bottom of the eighth. One out into the game is Mariano Rivera.
Sixth appearance for Mariano Rivera on the season. The record of 1-1, 5.79 ERA. Only 4 2/3 innings, 3 hits allowed, and 3 earned runs. We mentioned that last outing. The walk-off home run to Marco Scudero. That was at Oakland last Sunday. Jason Veritek, 7-for-25, 1 career home run.
Well, the home run for Jason Veritek, his first of the year. Back in the fourth inning, which at the time tied the game 2-2. As a pass to Mariano Rivera, you go back to April of 05, able to take him deep. The only time he's ever taken him deep at the time to give the Red Sox a tie ball game. But of course, the other captain later in that game, Derek Jeter, with the walk-off home run to win it for the Yankees on that day game from Yankee Stadium in April of 2005. And here they match up tonight, Red Sox trailing by 3. As Veritek represents the tying run. With one out in the bottom of the eighth. Ball one from Rivera. Veritek not only with the home run tonight, he singled his last time up, a 2-for-3 night. Rally caps are on. Red Sox down by 3. A strike, and it's 1-1 to Veritek. .413 career saves, ranks fourth on baseball's all-time list. To Mariano Rivera. Veritek sends it foul off to the left. John Franco is third with 424. Rivera at 413 right now. His 413 are the most ever in the American League.
And he's working on the final year of his contract here with the Yankees. Chuck lifts it foul down the left field line. About the quiet disappearance of Bernie Williams. Tried to invite him in spring training to a minor league contract. Bernie wanted no part of that. And not back with the Yankees in 2007.
Seems strange that he's not with the Yankees, and I know it's strange for a lot of his former teammates.
He did a very solid job for him last season.
Sure did. The 1-2. Pettitte fouls it off to the left. Mariano Rivera has made 203 more appearances than any other pitcher in Yankees history. With 725 total appearances, David Getty is second at 522. So far and away the most for Rivera. To right field and in for a hit for Pettitte. From third comes Manny Ramirez, and it's now a two-run game, 6-4 Yankees. Third hit of the night for Jason Pettitte.
The cut fastball from Rivera stays out over the plate, and Pettitte with the line drive base hit. Big night, the home run, two more hits to add to that. A three RBI night for Pettitte. You look back at this inning, Don. I thought that Joe Torre was going to have Myers with the lead pitch to Ortiz, Manny, and then J.D. Drew. But that didn't happen. He got him out of there right after Ortiz. And now into the third pitcher in this inning.
Crisp chops it down the first baseline. Around from second base comes Mike Lowell. That's in the corner and trouble. Pettitte being waved all the way around. The Red Sox will tie the score as to third goes Coco Crisp. Back of the Sox in the eighth.
And it couldn't come for a better time for Coco Crisp, who has been struggling. He did have a couple of bunt hits last night, his second hit tonight. And this Fenway crowd has been waiting for that from Coco Crisp. A ground ball right down the first baseline. McCabe is playing well off the bag. And once it gets by him, the game's going to be tied in Coco Crisp in the third base. Well, Cora's at the plate now in a tie ball game. Always the possibility of a squeeze.
In all the way around as Cora bats. And fouls it off to the left.
Infield playing in, and Coco on contact was off on that pitch. So any kind of ground ball looks like he's going to try to score on contact.
A four-run bottom of the eighth inning has tied the score at six. The go-ahead run 90 feet away for Boston. With one out in the eighth. Cora wants to see the signs from DeMarlo Hale again, who's come down the line.
Looks like DeMarlo Hale looking in the dugout trying to get the signs himself. That's why he's walked that far down. He didn't have a set of signs, and now he gives them to Cora.
Everybody on the same page now. The count of 0-1 to Cora.
Squeeze not likely, 0-1.
Cora in the center field. From third comes Crisp. The Red Sox take the lead.
Well, how about what Alex Cora has done for the Red Sox in the last two games? He had a spectacular game last night in Toronto, hitting that triple in the ninth inning. And now with the infield in, making contact, just pushing the ball up over the head of Derek Jeter. And the Red Sox, with five runs here in the eighth, take the lead. Rivera has not recorded an out.
Lugo, the eighth batter in the eighth inning. There goes Cora at first. The pitch, a ball, the throw. is in time.
That's a heck of a tag there by Cano. Watch Cano have to come up the first base line to make the catch on this, then slap it down quickly, get the back of Cora before the hand gets to the bag. And if you look in the Red Sox bullpen, it's not Papelbon, Okajima loosening up for the Red Sox.
This one now to the backstop.
This ball way up over the head of Lugo. Lugo a little steer about back out at Rivera.
It's 57 career blown, but 11 against the Red Sox. And a strike, and it's 2-1 now to Lugo. Now the Yankees will be expecting Jeter, Abreu, and yes, Alex Rodriguez will have a chance.
And there's Okajima. We tell you, no Papelbon in this game tonight. After working back-to-back nights up in Toronto.
Lugo swings and foul, tips into the catcher's mitt, but the Red Sox, with a five-run bottom of the eighth, take a 7-6 lead. We head to the ninth.
Now through April 30th, simply sign your name during the Lincoln Signature Event. Now drive any 07 Lincoln with zero cash due at signing, including the new Lincoln MKZ with its award-winning interior. Get zero first month payment, zero down, and zero cash due at signing on Lincoln MKZ for $386 a month. Offer ends April 30th. See your Lincoln Mercury dealer now.
Yeah, I know.
No.
Mm-hmm. Oh. I see. Yeah, great.
Well, she wants a KFC famous bowl. You know, layers of her favorites. Mashed potatoes, corn, chicken, gravy, and cheese, all in a bowl.
Try KFC famous bowls. Freshly prepared with our home-style mashed potatoes, layered with sweet corn, all white meat crispy chicken, and topped with our signature gravy and three cheese blend. Dig into great layers of flavor with KFC famous bowls.
If you don't build the right deck in the first place, time and weather will just wear it away. So we engineered and treated our LP WeatherBest decking so it looks beautiful, lasts longer, and needs less maintenance. That leaves more time for what you really want to do on a deck. Nothing at all. We're not looking for a genius grant, just ways to make life easier. That's what we do. We make the products that build the homes simply better. LP Building Products. Build with us.
You are our neighbors. You teach. You cheer. You sacrifice. You help those around you. You love your little corner of the world. Here at Extra Mart, we are proud to serve you, and we thank you for letting us be a part of your community.
Visit the new ExtraMart.com and sign up for the Extra Email Club and have a chance to win a PlayStation 3. Club members are the first to learn about great context, incredible sales, receive coupons, and more. Go to ExtraMart.com today.
Boston Red Sox baseball on NESN is brought to you by New England Ford Dealers, Sovereign Bank, the official bank of the Red Sox cable network, Kia, Auto Trader, Clay Chevrolet, Acura, and by Southwest Airlines. The Red Sox have taken a 7-6 lead with five in the eighth. As Kyle Snyder was warming up in between innings, Okajima was not quite ready. So after a few warm-up tosses, Terry Francona came out and took Snyder out of the game. And Hideki Okajima now into the game to pitch the ninth without Jonathan Papelbon available.
Well, think about this now for Okajima, right? The guy that's got all the attention is Daisuke, obviously. Okajima in his first Red Sox-Yankees rivalry game, and here he is trying to close out a ball game because Papelbon is not available. See the numbers over the last three games. Struck out 6 of 8 batters he's faced. So altogether 8 strikeouts in 6 2/3. This is the 7th appearance for Okajima. This is quite a story.
Well, what an inning. Talk about stories for the Red Sox. Jason Varitek with a huge hit for the Red Sox. It's been a big night for Varitek. The triple down the line for Crisp. And then the go-ahead base hit into center field for Alex Cora, who has been outstanding for the Red Sox in the last 2 days. And his first chapter in this great rivalry this season in 2007. Well, it's been a great ball game tonight, and the Red Sox have pulled ahead. But a long way to go, as they've got to deal with Jeter, Abreu, and Alex Rodriguez here in the ninth. And Hideki Yokojima. Derek Jeter tonight has popped out to third, walk, single, and grounded to short.
You know, you think back to spring training, Don, when Papelbon was still in the rotation, the big question, who's going to close out games? Well, here you have the first opportunity where you don't have Papelbon available, and it's a guy you'd never expected to be out there.
Okajima was not one of the names mentioned. From bouncing in. Red Sox got 7 tonight from Curt Schilling. Touch for 5 runs. J.C. Romero in a third, giving up a run. Kyle Snyder 2/3. And now Hideki Yokojima pitching the ninth.
There is action behind Okajima in the Red Sox bullpen.
It's Joel Pinheiro, who had been up earlier. He's back up again. He was up in the sixth. That's behind Jeter, 2-0. Okajima had a very good outing in Toronto, striking out the side in order. There's a strike to Jeter, 2-1.
One of his lefties that comes right over the top with a fastball, curveball, and a splitter. And of course, with that splitter, that makes him somewhat effective against right-handed hitters. He's not a specialist just to try to get lefties out.
Off the end of the bat, cued towards second, Cora to his left. Throws out Jeter for the first out of the ninth.
That's the splitter we were talking about. That's a pitch that was very effective for him up in Toronto in that 3 strikeout inning he had. Not a lot of dip to this one, but certainly toward the end of the bat for Derek Jeter. Jeter's looking toward the left side of the infield, but the ball's shooting to second base.
Here's Bobby Abreu with 1 down in the ninth. Out of the track and center in the first, struck out, single in the fifth, struck out in the seventh. Saw the 41 saves. Hideki Yokojima in Japan, but here getting his first taste of Red Sox Yankees. Blows it by Abreu that time, 1-1.
And a fastball at about 88 miles an hour again. Okajima not overpowering by any means with his fastball. Looks like he's gonna have a heart attack.
One and two as he jumps ahead of Abreu.
That's the splitter again from Okajima.
2-2. What the Jim able to get Jeter for the first out of the ninth. He deals with Abreu now, A-Rod next. Just missing, framed by Veritek. Well, it does not get the corner full count.
I don't think Abreu would have had an argument if he'd been called out on strikes. Daisuke wanted that one.
Abreu will walk down to first base.
Now this will be interesting. Do you stay with Okajima? You got A-Rod coming to the plate. Pinheiro. A-Rod 4-for-25 against Pinheiro, but it looks like Terry's going to stay with Okajima.
And a tying run for New York at first with one down. And the numbers against Pinheiro. It is Okajima who will face A-Rod. And a strike to Rodriguez. And fly to the warning track in the second inning. But then homered in the fourth and in the fifth.
Now this was really his show until the last inning by the Red Sox.
Away and it's 1-1. It was an amazing 12 home runs in the first 15 games of the year. And we mentioned the walk-off victory yesterday against the Cleveland Indians. 2-1. Pinch runner for Giambi earlier. Thompson waits on deck. Three and one. Abreu at first, one down in the ninth. The strike, A-Rod thought he had ball four.
Now, no giving in with the fastball in. A-Rod on the 3-1 count. Okajima goes to the curveball to pick up strike two.
The 3-2 pitch. Rodriguez loops it to second. Cora's got it. Looks the runner back. A-Rod is gone. Two down in the ninth.
Jammed him just a little bit, didn't he, with that fastball. A-Rod puts it on a line, but a soft line drive to second base. So a 3-2 fastball. That right about at the label, a little above the label.
Two down now for Thompson, with Abreu still at first. Strike one to Thompson. Evan Thompson pinch ran for Giambi in the eighth. 1-for-3 so far in the season. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Thompson stays alive as he grounds it foul over by the Yankees dugout. Hideki Okajima working the ninth in the absence of Jonathan Papelbon has the first two outs of the ninth. The 0-2 pitch. Lifted down the right field line. Over goes Drew, but it's back into the seats. The Red Sox score five times in the bottom of the eighth. And try to grab their first win of the season against the Yankees. They check it first. And back easily as Abreu, the lead was very short.
Not a bad idea, though. Let Abreu know that you're conscious of him being there. Abreu has good speed. He can steal bases.
The 0-2 pitch. And handcuffs Veritek, knocks it down.
Nice play by Veritek. Split it down in the dirt. Veritek thinking about nothing but blocking that ball and keeping in front of him and keeping Abreu at first base.
Okajima's throwing 21 pitches here in the ninth. Struck him out, the Red Sox win. For Boston.
And the final pitch, the split-fingered fastball from Okajima. It's Thompson. Couldn't control the head of the bat. And what an ending to this game. I mean, to get to Rivera and then Okajima, the precious situation of coming in the first Yankee Red Sox game and picks up the save in a one-run ball game.
Seven to six, the final. WB Mason's extra innings right around the corner, so stay with us. Jerry and I'll be back here in Fenway Park right after this.
We're America's largest refiner, and some of the vehicles we fuel don't travel on roads. For those that do, we make some of the cleanest gasoline on the planet, and every drop is performance guaranteed. And our employees contribute over 200,000 hours a year in our communities. We know you probably don't think about these things when you think of Valero. That's okay. Just as long as when you do think of us, you think of this. Valero, the energy to take you anywhere.
The import with a taste as big as Canada. Molson Canadian. Here's to good nature.
Now you see me? Now you don't. Now you see me? Now you don't. What you are seeing is how much farther, wider, and better you'll see with new Silver Star Ultra headlights from Sylvania. Because the next time you see me, I may not be alone. See farther, see wider, see better. New Silver Star Ultra headlights from Sylvania.
With features like remote power liftgate, remote engine starter, rear backup camera and navigation system. In Jeep Commander or Jeep Grand Cherokee, you can escape to the wilderness. And when necessary, you can escape from it. And now, qualified returning Daimler Chrysler lessees can get a low mileage lease on Grand Cherokee Laredo for $279 a month.
Well, the Red Sox win game one of this series in exciting fashion, 7-6. The play of the game is brought to you by Foxwoods Resort Casino. And Jason Veritek with a big night tonight. The two-run home run to the opposite field off Andy Pettitte. And later on in the ball game, Veritek with a base hit off Mariano Rivera.
The final score again, 7-6. The Red Sox win the first one. For Jerry Remy and Tina Sebastian, Donald Sillo saying goodnight from Fenway. Visit Nesson.com or New England Sports Live Online. This has been a presentation of Nesson, New England's most watched sports network. Stay tuned next for WB Mason. Next Trippers with Tom Barron and Dennis Eckersley.
Where do we begin? What a great night of baseball at Fenway Park. As you know, yesterday the Yankees overcame a 6-2 deficit in the ninth. Well, tonight it was the Red Sox coming back down 6-2 in the eighth inning. And Mariano Rivera blows a save in his second straight appearance. And a new savior coming in for the ninth inning. Hideki Okajima gets his first major league save. Sox win 7-6. Break it all down for you on WB Mason's Extra Innings next.
Captioning provided by Finagle Bagel, Austin's best sandwich, soup, salad, and of course, Bagel Cafe, with 20 locations in Eastern Mass.
Every texture, every line, every nuance, created with one thing in mind. From Lexus. At Lexus of Portland.
So easy to turn. So easy to handle. It almost drives itself. But it's not just about mowing the lawn. It's also about owning a John Deere. Easy Track. The newest John Deere.
A 95-mile-an-hour fastball will reach home plate in 0.4 seconds. Watch every pitch in clear Panasonic motion. Panasonic Plasma, for the speed of sports. Panasonic, ideas for life.
Have you seen the coolest crossover to hit the streets? It's the all-new Ford Edge, featuring a class-exclusive Vista roof to see more. MP3 jack that allows you to take your tunes on the road with you, and best-in-class horsepower. Get the all-new Ford Edge. With zero-down lease an Edge for just $299 a month and get a premium maintenance plan at no extra charge. Only at your local Ford store.
Why should your company switch to Comcast Workplace? Because it's up to twice as fast as DSL. McAfee security is included. And 24-hour tech support means less downtime. There's also business email and website solutions. Everything you need to keep your small business, well, buzzing.
When your kids get what they want, you'll get what you want. now at the Dodge National Minivan Sale. Get a factory-installed rear seat DVD player at no extra charge. Plus a cash allowance of $4,000 on America's best-selling minivan, Dodge Grand Caravan, with two rows of stow-and-go seats. Your kids will thank you, and you'll thank us. Discover America's hottest products at your Dodge dealer.
What a win for the Red Sox. The manager's at the podium. Let's listen to Terry Francona live.
Is good for our staff, good for our team. To win a game like that against that team is very helpful. It'll help down the road.
Why Okajima?
Pardon?
Why Okajima? What did you like about him in that spot?
He's been so... their lefties hadn't seen him. And with his changeup, he's been so dominant versus righties. And he throws strikes.
Can you talk about Chris's at bat and also his effort on
The effort on the home run, he was so close to not letting that ball go out. He may have gone out with it, but that was a great effort. And then he comes back, and again, we strung together some pretty good at-bats that inning. Even to start out with, David facing Myers, where there's not much happening, but because he stayed on him and drove the ball, all of a sudden they have to make some moves and, get to Mo before they wanted to, and we continued to have some good at-bats.
What was the intensity level like with that? I was just watching that game unfold.
It was going quick, and the closer we get, I'll admit there's some anxiety because Pap's not pitching. It's nice to look down there and see that big boy throwing, but it was an exciting night for us to run Oki out there and watch what he did. That game, you saw the excitement on everybody's faces. That gives everybody a big lift. No, I did. I patted him on the chest. I think I knocked him back about 2 feet. And then we were going to go talk to him when Alex came up. And we decided the best coaching right there is stay out of the way. We had Masai writing stuff down on a card that this guy's a really good hitter. stuff like that. I think he knew. So I think we just said, the best thing we can do is stay out of the way. He looked like he was throwing the ball pretty well. Jason swung the bat very well tonight. We gave Willie Mo a shot earlier he's a big, strong kid, maybe you have a shot there, but it was nice to see Coco, Jason swing. And that's the way, you have to have production from your whole lineup if you're going to win.
Been around Alex, still kind of amazed just to see him kind of keep up that pace the way he did tonight.
We tried to. We were certainly hoping to start the series to maybe establish, okay, it's a new series. Maybe get him off some pitches, and we let him extend his hands, especially the three-run homer. If we continue to do that, he feels so good about himself right now. He's hitting pitches. That ball's probably an inch or two off the plate. And he drove it to right center like a left-hand hitter, like we see Manny do. We're going to have to do a better job because he's, if not the most dangerous hitter in the league, and feeling good about himself. That's a bad combination for us.
Terry, what happens between Schill and Tech right before that pitch? The fastball up there?
What happened? Well, that's just changing signs or going without a sign. When they have runners on base, we'd sometimes prefer to just not put down a sign. We don't want to give him any help. He doesn't need it.
How gutsy was the decision to throw him a fastball on that 3-2 pitch in the
night? I don't know about gutsy. He had set up a lot of pitches Again, we're not looking for walks at that point, but he commands his fastball and he throws a changeup for a strike, so it makes that fastball look a little faster than it is. Well, I mean, I don't know that you can expect every night guys to get a bunch of hits. It's nice to see. I mean, we're thrilled, but you know, again, we talk about it so much. When he doesn't hit, we can still win. But when he adds his offense, it certainly gives us a big lift.
Alex Cora 2 days in a row, I guess.
Yeah, and again, circumstances quickly turned in our favor. I mean, we're battling uphill, and then all of a sudden, they got to play the infield in, and he stayed on. And Alex is smart. And again, he didn't drive it, but he stayed on it long enough to get it over the infield. That's all we needed at that point. We have speed at third, and all of a sudden, that's the first time all night we were actually in a good position.
Jerry, as much as you respect Rivera, is there anything that has more reason to have confidence against
him? Well, you know, on the flip side, we see him more than anybody. That's not good either. That means they're winning most of, you know, too much. I just, again, he is so good, and he's been so good for so long. But the ultimate, or the, you know, the only other thing to do is quit and, you know, go home. We're not going to do that. So we try to do the best you can. But he is one of the very, very best. We just, we don't quit playing, thankfully.
Okay. We're going to have Curt Schilling and then Hideki Okajima.
That was Terry Francona after the game, a night in which the Red Sox wore the green uniforms in honor of the late Red Auerbach and Virginia Tech logos to honor those fallen in the tragedy at Virginia Tech. The Red Sox hand the ball to Curt Schilling tonight, and Alex Rodriguez hits a solo homer, his 11th of the year, and he just keeps on rolling. That's a 1-0 lead for the Yankees on a solo shot. Now it's 2-0 after the homer. Then a three-run shot here in the fifth. 12 homers in 15 games for A-Rod, despite a great effort there by Coco Crisp. Crisp will get a better effort here in the eighth as the rally is on, and his triple brings in two runs. And a good job by the fans not touching that ball. Crisp goes to third. Lowell Veritek score. Game tied at six. And then Alex Cora, yesterday's hero, steps in and delivers again tonight. The next batter, Mariano Rivera, for the second straight outing. Blows the save as the Red Sox rally to win 7-6. Is the final. They put up five in the eighth inning. A 13-hit attack, a rousing victory tonight at Fenway Park. Welcome to WB Mason's Extra Innings. Everyone, Tom Garrett, along with Hall of Famer Dennis Eckersley, and this is remarkable stuff. That was a great ball game.
It's a great way to start it. You know, you don't know what to talk about. We had everything planned, and everything just, it's a good way to mess it up. You know, the Red Sox way, because we had a lot going on for the Yankees. A-Rod's night, they turned it around.
Yeah, this was all going to be about A-Rod tonight until that bottom of the eighth. And three pitchers come through. And we could talk a little about Joe Torre, how he decided to handle this. Mike Myers comes in to face Ortiz, just one batter. Vizcaino comes in. He doesn't do much, and he struggled yesterday against Cleveland. And you hand it over to Mariano Rivera, rested since Sunday. But you remember Sunday, a walk-off homer to Marco Scudero, and Rivera didn't have much going tonight.
Well, he didn't. You know, he was pitching away to Veritek. He finally threw him a cutter inside, not very good, left it up and out over. Didn't even get in on him very much. And then Crispy throws a cutter. He didn't really hit it very hard, but perfectly placed down the right field line, stays right there, goes all the way down, takes forever to get it out of there. Veritek could score all the way from first. That tells you something right there. Big hit by Crisp right there. Real big hit. Ties the game. And then this is next hit coming up is like the World Series 2001. Jam shot, Cora. Doesn't even get to the outfield grass. But the fact of the matter is that ball's up. It didn't get way in on him, but it still jammed him, but he fought it off infield in. Big hit, 7-6-W.
Now, there aren't many times we ever talk about a team coming back to beat Mariano Rivera, but how about that? Second time or second straight blown save this season. Last time he did that back in 2005. Against the Red Sox. Of course, it happened in 2004 in October. Here's what happened Sunday. Scudero with the three-run home run, and that was two outs, nobody on, and he gave up a single, a walk, and a three-run home.
I mean, it gets away from you. I think he's down the bullpen tonight, 6-2 game, thinking, you know, he's probably thinking he's not even going to get into this game. You know, if you have to go back over this game from the other side of the field, You know, Joe Torre has a lot of explaining to do. I mean, if you go, I'd have a hard time explaining this game if I was a Yankee analyst.
Why take Proctor out in the first place?
I don't understand. First of all, Proctor's probably been out there so many times already as it is. He figured, he's done enough. Let's get him out of there. I don't want to overwork him, save him for the rest of the weekend. That's probably what he's thinking. But Vizcaino, who gave it up yesterday, goes out there again, didn't have anything, and it just makes the job to Rivera that much tougher. Meanwhile, he just didn't have it tonight. His cutter wasn't cutting, and the ball's up a little bit, and he didn't get away with anything.
And the Sox rally after Andy Pettitte looked very good through his start tonight. Okay, now, Sunday night, Daisuke Matsuzaka on the mound, and you can commemorate Daisuke's first game at Fenway. It's a limited edition collector's item. Includes an actual piece of MLB authenticated used baseball from a Daisuke game and a commemorative photo. This set is $119.95, limited to only 2007 individually hand-numbered pieces. Call 866-280-BATS or go to BigTimeBats.com or HamsterDirect.com to order or for more information. Let's go back to the ballpark, check in with Tina Servasio.
Tom, a very exciting comeback victory for the Red Sox as they defeat the Yankees 7-6 with a 5-run eighth inning. And Alex Cora does it again for the second night in a row, driving in the winning run. We will talk to Alex Cora. He's coming up next. Plus, I'll go one-on-one with the manager, Terry Francona. We'll get post-game reaction from both clubhouses. I'll be talking to the Red Sox. And, of course, they'll be getting ready for Josh Beckett to go out on the hill and try to do it again for the Red Sox tomorrow afternoon. But for now, let's send it back to our Nesson studios and see what's going on with Sports Desk and Hazel May.
Hey, Tina, thank you. Hi, everybody. Coming up in our postgame update, details on Celtics point guard Sebastian Telfair's recent run-in with the law, and OSU freshman Greg Oden is one step closer to possibly wearing green next season. We'll tell you why. That's just around the corner. More of our postgame show after this. Back in a moment.
The Subaru Dealers of New England all-wheel deal sales event is going on now. Buy a brand new 2007 all-wheel drive Subaru Forester, Car and Driver's best small SUV for the past 3 years in a row, and get $2,000 cash back, plus 1.9% financing. Buy a new Forester for only $19,395. Go to NewEnglandSubaru.com for a list of local dealers.
Subaru.
Feel the freedom with $2,000 cash back, plus 1.9% financing.
Have you heard about the benefits of a reverse mortgage? If you're a homeowner, 62 years or older, and would like to supplement your monthly income, a reverse mortgage could be the key to living comfortably in retirement. U.S. government-insured reverse mortgages allow seniors to convert the equity in their home into cash without having to move or make monthly loan payments. We offer a free information kit and video explaining everything you need to know about a reverse mortgage.
Call 800-300-4519.
Gotta have to get it.
Running out of paper for the big report, Herb Blewett wholeheartedly panics.
Gotta have to get it.
Don't panic, Herb. Just call 1-888-WB-MASON.
I gotta have to get it today.
Call by 11, you'll get it the very same day. Coffee paper, toner, bathroom supplies, even staples. So who do you call when you gotta have to get it today? Who but WB Mason?
My neighbor drove all over town to find the best deal on a cell phone. I just logged on to Let's Talk. They make it easy to compare plans from all major carriers and find cell phone deals that are much cheaper than retail.
Like the hot BlackBerry Pearl with music and video player, a $369 value, yours free after mail-in rebate and new calling plan.
Let's Talk has the best prices, the best plans, and the most free phones guaranteed.
Log on to 25letstalk.com or call now to order your BlackBerry Pearl. Let's Talk, the smarter way to shop for cell phones. So log on or call now.
What a night for Jason Parratek. He had three hits, including a big two-run homer. That gave it a fourth inning. It's really all they could get going off Andy Pettitte. He only gave up eight hits and those two runs. It's his first of 2007. Jason Parratek delivers with three RBI, 3-for-4 night. He's up to 244 now. And he's our Subaru star of the game with that home run. And, of course, the big hit that kept the rally going in the eighth inning, the first hit off of Mariano Rivera. He was the first man to face the close. He's our Subaru star of the game, brought to you by the Subaru Dealers of New England. Think, feel, drive. And Jason Parratek of the Red Sox, an improbable comeback against the game's best closer, Mariano Rivera, allows them to battle back in the bottom of the eighth. The Coco Crisp triple ties it up with two runs coming in. He stays at third, and the next man delivers. Alex Cora drives in the game-winning run for the second straight game.
After the game, he spoke with Tina.
All right, Tom, thank you so much. Alex Cora, for the second night in a row, drives in the winning run. Jonathan Papelbon just came over to congratulate you and talked about a chocolate cookie. What's that all about?
Yeah, he said to have a chocolate cookie. You know, I've been on a diet lately, so he said to have one is going to have a game-winning home run or a save. So it worked out good, a game-winning bloop single.
Oh, there you go, that game-winning hit. Alex, how was this another example of a great team effort in this comeback rally?
We kept putting good at-bats. It started with David, then Manny, and all the way down to the lineup. And Jason Veritek had a great one with Mariano, and Coco came up huge. You know, I had the easy one. You know, I mean, fill in and try to put the ball in play. You know, got lucky there. But everybody did a great job, and the bullpen without Pap tonight, you know, did awesome. It was a great win.
How about Hideki Okajima? And he's a Major League Baseball rookie. And the way he showed himself out there to the Yankees after watching the way Mariano Rivera fell apart a little bit there.
He looked like a veteran guy out there. Yeah, it's his first year in the United States, and you know, come here in this atmosphere and do it against the Yankees. It was great for him, so hopefully he can keep going.
All right, Alex, second night in a row. Good job.
Thank you.
Tom, back to you.
Tina, thanks very much. So the Red Sox get the win. And nailing it down in the ninth inning, Hideki Okajima. He steps in. We'll talk more about his save tonight on WB Mesa Delivery of the Game. He gets it done facing the meat of the Yankees order, striking out the pinch hitter Thompson, or pinch runner earlier for Giambi Thompson, in the ninth after he got A-Rod and started the inning off with Jeter. So a great effort for the first Major League save for Okajima.
Hey, Les.
What's up? It's Tom.
Hi, Vince.
It's Tom.
Hi, Dave.
Felipe.
Hi, Xavier.
Hello, Terry.
Hey, Floyd.
What up, Steve-O?
What up, Ken?
How's it going, Jebediah?
It's Tom.
Double brewed iced coffee in your favorite flavors, served just the way you like it. Come on, who knows you better than Dunkin' Donuts? America runs on Dunkin'.
Enjoy a new Berry Berry Donut and a Berry Berry flavored iced coffee. It's a combination of raspberry and blueberry.
We make our sauce fresh all day, so dishes like our penne puttanesca are delicious all the time. Bertucci's, what's not to love?
So every month you sit down to pay the bills. Oh joy. But what if you could do the whole thing online in less than half the time? If you used Sovereign Bank Bill Pay, you wouldn't have to buy stamps or write checks. To see how fast and simple it is, log on to sovereignbank.com and check out Bill Pay. It's free, so give it a try. You'll never go back to the old way. And it'll give you more time to do things like
watch baseball.
Hello?
Mrs. Anderson, this is Mark Brown. I'm from the collections department.
Hi. Listen, I'm sorry I haven't made my payment yet. I'll get it in as soon as I can.
Maybe you should call In Charge. They'll work with you and come up with a solution that's right for you.
When life hands you a little more than you can manage, call In Charge Debt Solutions. We're a nonprofit company that puts people back in control by helping them manage their debt. We'll stop the collection calls, and we'll help lower your interest rates, so you'll have one affordable monthly payment. Call In Charge today.
I think the buildup gets old. You know, every time we come here or they come to New York, they're trying to build it up like it's the World Series. You know, we play these guys 19 times a year. It's always exciting because the fans make for a great atmosphere, but you know, you try to treat it like any other game.
Hey, a little bit of breaking news we want to send along. Gary DeSarcina, who sat in this chair last year, has just been named the manager of the Lowell Spinners, the short season single A team. So see,
yeah,
you play your cards right, you could be manager next year. But congratulations to Garrett Mahl.
Yeah,
great guy and great baseball
mind. I think that's something
mind.
He wants to do. He wants to be on the field.
You missed a lot if you weren't watching before the game tonight. We had the 90-minute pregame show. And coming up on Monday, we've got another 90-minute pregame show. Monster Monday coming your way as the Jays come to town, and Tomooka faces the Red Sox once again. Tim Wakefield has been dominant in his first three starts. Of course, love team coverage as the Boston Globe writers. Gordon needs a big part to cover all the bases. Red Sox get the win as they rally tonight to Curt Schilling, taking off the hook as he gave up the five runs, battled through seven innings of work tonight, and the bullpen picked him up, and the offense was there at the end. Let's hear from Curt Schilling down at the podium.
Well, they both were frustrating. The first one was an 0-1 fastball that I made it was middle, knee-high down the middle. And when he's not on fire, he hits it. The only surprise was that it didn't land somewhere in the Bronx. Second one was not as bad a pitch as I thought it was at first, but he's seeing the ball so well, and he's so comfortable with the plate right now. And he stayed on it. He's so strong, and he's so strong the other way. And his ball carries differently than most other guys in the game. About the next pitch, we're talking about the next pitch. Well, Decky, I mean, the fact of the matter is, getting into that inning, I always feel like every year when you're on a team, you have to come back and win one to kind of start doing it. Yesterday was the first time we really came back and won, and doing what we did, a lot of momentum, and all of a sudden, it's not going to be Paps, and his last outing, Hideki's, he was awesome. And I think he's absolutely flown under the radar as far as I think he's probably a little bit better than people thought he might be outside of the clubhouse. So, this was a win, and championship teams you win championships with a full roster of players. Alex doing what he did yesterday, today, Hideki doing what he did. I mean, it takes every guy on your roster has to help you win a ball game throughout the course of a season. And there's some guys that aren't here will help you win games. And to see them get in the mix this early and make it happen is a really nice thing to see. Well, that was the other huge part of this, was that two guys who are grinding away and working as hard as they can to try and contribute and be a part of this. Were huge. Tech hits a home run, and at that point I'm thinking this game's gonna be tied if we don't score again, because I'm not, it's lift, and for him to hit it the right field, and it was nice. But then Coco with the huge triple, and again, there's a lot of side stories to this win that everybody should be feeling real, real good about what we did tonight. No, I just bowed politely. It's great. That's great to see, though. It really is.
All right, that's Curt Schilling at the podium. And like all of us here, he's talking about Hideki Okajima. He's now retired 17 of 18 batters, 7 scoreless innings since he gave up that home run on the first pitch of his major league career. One of, 7 pitchers to do that? But he looks very impressive against both lefties and righties.
I told you I like this guy. I like that little forkball he throws down away to right-handers. And he had a couple tonight to face. Right from the get-go, he gets Jeter to pull off and just cue shot to second base. Great little forkball down and away. First out. Then he almost paints Abreu and then walks him on a 3-2 pitch. The pitch before, I thought, was strike three. Could have rung him up. A-Rod, 3-1 pitch, curveball. Nice, just flips it in there. Hasn't thrown a fastball yet. 3-2 pitch, fastball jams him. And that's probably the pitch of the whole inning right there, because this guy's on fire. Hadn't thrown him a fastball, had enough